This is Movies in Contemplation with Jirak and...
Oh, am I talking to
Jesus.
You?
Yeah.
I will never find another lover sweeter than you, sweeter than you.
And I will never... Hello, everybody. We are back.
We are back again.
Wearing this fucking thing.
I don't know why you're wearing those headphones.
I don't know why I was wearing them. All right. Hey, everybody. Welcome back. Sorry about the break, but
I'm not, because
it was well needed and fucking great.
Yes, we were on a little vacay to...
The
West Coast, my hometown in Cali.
Yeah.
It was super fun. We'll talk about little things here and there about the trip, because how can we not?
Cali.
We were in L.A.
We in L.A., bitch.
Yeah.
Well, we was.
And speaking of... L.A.
Oh, yeah. The film. Ingrid Goes West.
Yes.
Callie's pick today.
I thought it would be perfect for the movie to be a very L.A. movie. And this is, like, to me, the most current L.A. film.
Yeah.
It came out in 2017, but it's still... I think it's a great film.
Good.
Yeah, because I... Oh, wait, well, let's do our business first.
Oh, we got to do our business.
Yeah, we got our business first, and then we'll talk about the film. Hold up. So, since we were doing Ingrid Goes West...
Oh, yeah.
...and we're doing this great film, I decided to change up our wine choice for this episode.
So excited.
Oh, I know. I got us Yes Way Rosé.
Yes Way Rosé.
We are drinking rosé wine. Ladies, gentlemen, and everybody in between.
Yeah, let's see how it is.
Yeah, we haven't even tried it yet. Yeah, cheers.
Fuck it. Oh! It's fucking gross.
Yes. You know,
y'all can keep your white wine. It's disgusting.
Yeah, we're not one for the whites and the rosés, but we're doing it for you, Ingrid.
White wine, it's the worst! It's the meanest!
Oh, that's right.
It's the meanest white wine.
All right, next business.
Next business.
What do we got?
We got the handy dandy Shakespearean notebook.
Notebook. Yeah. Okay. I haven't picked one, actually. Usually we have
I opened it for you, and that was supposed to be it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
But go ahead.
But it's my movie, so I'm supposed to pick.
Okay, well, random it.
Dear.
God.
Thank you for finishing my sentence.
You're welcome.
All right, let's see what I got. Cuckoldly... Motley-minded fleshmonger. I think we've done the fleshmonger, but it's okay. I'm
pretty sure we've done cuckoldly.
Really? I don't think we've done that. Okay. So cuckoldly having the qualities of a cuckold.
Oh no, we haven't.
No, we haven't.
A cuckold.
Haplessly victimized.
A cuckold. They're getting cheated on. Cuckold.
I guess.
Right?
I'm happy to be a victim. I guess. Anyway.
Yeah.
Motley-minded. Foolish.
Foolish.
Fleshmonger. Fornicator.
Well. Okay, then. We got a fucking...
Hold on.
A cheater. Two different versions of saying a cheater.
Yeah. Right. And a victim. Okay. This will be interesting, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes with the film.
Let's see how it is. All right.
Let's see what you guys think. Yeah, moving on.
So, Callie, what does this film mean to you?
I love this film because it portrays, like, the dark, obsessive side of social media.
Yeah.
And also, like obsessive personality.
Mm-hmm.
I love that it's so unique, and it's a more powerful movie than people, I think, gave it credit for, because it got, like, a 6.6, I think, on IMDb.
Hmm.
Oh, I didn't say, before I really dive in. So, yes, Ingrid Goes West, 2017, with Aubrey Plaza, Elizabeth Olsen, and O'Shea Jackson Jr. And it was directed by Matt Spicer. I kind of looked up his stuff. I think he's been, like, more known for, like, TV and stuff.
He hasn't done
too many things. But also, I didn't notice until the credits that Aubrey Plaza produced the film.
Yeah. That Parks and Rec check, I guess.
Oh, yeah, the Parks and Rec checks. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, yeah, it's very unique, and it doesn't, like, I don't think it, like, defends online obsession, and it doesn't, like, humor it either. It's, like, it doesn't, like, humor the idea that like online attention is important.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Does that make sense? No? Okay.
Agree to disagree.
Agree to disagree?
Yeah.
Okay. Agree to disagree. We'll
get to that.
We will dissect that.
Yeah.
And I love that it pokes fun at LA people.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
It's so good.
Especially like the hipster.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it also shows that social media is a facade.
Telling everyone you see like Vic and her and you and me pretends to be a pillar of society.
Yeah, it is.
So, yeah.
All right.
Let's
lead us in.
Lead us in. And what's funny, like, people thought that this movie was going to be a comedy, which it is.
Oh, yeah.
But it's a dark comedy.
Oh, yeah.
Very dark comedy.
Well, the trailer made it look like a horror film.
Yeah, it did. Yeah. But it's funny. I was looking at other people's like reviews on IMDb. I didn't go too far down that rabbit hole, but a lot of people were defending it, saying, for those of you that are bashing this film for not being funny, it is funny, but your humor...
I thought the seriousness of it was funny. That's what made it funny.
Exactly.
And that's the type of comedy that we like.
Yes,
we like
we
serious fucking funny. But again, that shows you the fucking idiocy of some people who are just like, they need that Seth Rogen fucking pushed nudge and a wink comedy.
Yeah.
You know, people love that spoon-fed shit. And I will never understand.
Yeah, but that's what I love about movies. Like, there are so many movies that cater to, like, everybody.
Right.
You know? That's just it. Like, some people's humor is totally
absolutely
different than ours, and that's totally fine and acceptable.
Absolutely.
This is me being so PC.
And I'm not, and I'm not bashing the Seth, because I do like him.
No, he's very talented.
Yes, you all know.
Yes.
I just think a lot of his work is pushed, and it doesn't need to be Seth. Moving on.
Oh, yeah, moving on. So, let's get to the film. So, it starts off with Instagram. So the whole film, it's about Instagram.
Yeah.
If you will, to say your words.
If you will.
If you will.
Yeah.
So it starts off that someone's having a wedding.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's perfect.
It's the perfect wedding.
Hashtag blessed.
Hashtag the couple that does yoga together stays together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Winky emoji. It's really cute because it's narrated that part by the chick that it's the wedding, and oh my god, so happy I married this weirdo.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then with each post, there's like a like on everything. We find out that Ingrid is Aubrey Plaza.
Mm-hmm.
She's like in her car, liking all the stuff, and so it's making us think, okay, so this wedding is happening like right now.
Yeah.
So we see, like, Ingrid's face, and she's just, like, bawling, and, like, those obsessive eyes are just, like, you don't really know exactly what's going on.
Right.
And you don't, for, a little part of the film, you're kind of, like, left in the dark, but then, like, slowly they let us know what's happening. Turns out that Ingrid is, like, parked at the wedding location.
Right, she's at the, yeah.
Yeah, she comes out of her car, and she's wearing this, like, full-length gown, which, in my head, I'm thinking, this is what she was wearing. Like, maybe she was at the wedding. Like, I don't know. There are, like, a lot of questions.
Yeah.
And she's just, like, walking, like, super, like, determined and definitely pressed and mad about something. And she goes up to the chick that was making all those posts. I think her name was Charlotte.
Charlotte.
Like, hi, Charlotte. Oh, Ingrid, hi. And she says, like, congratulations.
Yeah.
And then,
thanks for inviting me to your wedding, you fucking cunt!
Yeah.
And then sprays her with fucking pepper spray.
Pepper sprays her in the fucking eyes. Oh my god. Like, what is going on? I love when movies just drop us in.
Yeah.
And we have no idea what's going on.
Right.
It's the best.
And then some random guy tackles her.
Yeah, she tries to run.
She tries to run away. So like, some random dude.
Like, lineback tackles her.
Yeah. And her drop was just so funny.
Her drop was funny. Very, very hard.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, and then the scene ends with the bride, like, blood curling, like, screaming. Just like, my day is ruined!
Right.
And then we get to Ingrid, who is now at a mental hospital.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's, like a resident place, and we hear her say, oh, dear Charlotte, you know, I'm doing so much better. And you kind of get little clips of her, like her day-to-day thing, like group therapy, taking her pills and meditating. And she's saying, I'm learning how to be present and I'm doing so much better. And I hope, you know, this doesn't ruin our friendship and we can look back at all this and laugh.
Yeah.
So what did you think was going on as like a first-time viewer for you so far?
Oh, well, she's fucking Josephine Goldberg.
Who?
She's Josephine Goldberg.
Who?
Joe Goldberg. Josephine Goldberg. She's a fucking stalker, dude.
I don't know why I cannot remember his full... You say his full name, and I'm like, who the fuck is that?
Who the fuck is Joe Goldberg? You. Hello, you. Cue Joe Goldberg.
Hello, you.
Yes, very, very that.
Fucking and I guess, stalker. I guess she's that's fucking...
that's a theme for me, maybe.
I guess. But she's a fucking stalker, and right up into the beginning of that film, like, and I'm really like, dude... And that's the thing with, like, social media. Mm-hmm. It's like, all of these fucking people follow us. You don't necessarily know who anybody is. And I know I'm just now reawakened my fucking Twitter.
Yes. Thank you, everybody, because I finally got Jirok to join me on social media because I, you know, I'm not great at it.
If it sounds like shit, it's me.
Sure.
Because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing.
I would love if, like people that, like, listen to us or even, like, know us, if they can... Definitely people that know us would know.
Right, right.
Who's writing what. But, yeah, he now has access to, like, our Twitter and Instagram and stuff just to kind of, like, help me do it because I procrastinate doing stuff. Or And here's the thing, like, with social media, too, and I'll dive into that more later, but there's a tendency to, like, overthink about what... to post because there's that fear of like looking bad or sounding stupid
or the
judgment.
I totally
we'll talk more about that, but yeah, it sounds like Ingrid is like writing Charlotte a letter, maybe like certain programs is it. Maybe she, like, had to write this, like, a fake letter.
Like a letter that wasn't going to her, but she had to write it.
Yeah, like making amends kind of thing.
Right, for the doctor.
For the doctors. But you can see that she's, like, a very good patient because she's doing everything. She's going through the motions. She's opening up, taking her pills. Like, she's doing what she's supposed to do. So she eventually gets out.
Right.
Because she's sitting out, I don't know what, she's probably waiting for a cab or something. And the first thing she pulls out is her phone. So I kind of got the idea of, okay, this is like diving into more of like the phone obsession thing that we all have.
Oh, yeah.
We all have it.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
To a certain extent. Everyone's different about it. She gets home and we kind of get a little more idea of her background, kind of her mom who... seemed like she was, like, very, very sick with some type of, like, cancer or something. They don't really say, but she passed away.
Yeah.
They don't say, like, when she passed away.
No, but we assume before the wedding thing, because she even said in her letter to Charlotte, she was like, when my mom died and da-da-da-da-da.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
But again, it makes you wonder, was she, though?
Was she, though?
Was she, though?
Well, yeah, and we kind of get... And we do learn more about it because she's home and she's just on her phone.
Right.
All day. Mm-hmm. She even falls asleep with her phone in her hand and her fucking alarm wakes her up.
Yeah.
But part of those scenes are like very real.
Yeah.
Like,
no,
we all
absolutely.
We all sit on the toilet and look on our phones.
Most of you who know me, if I'm texting you or if you receive a text from me, I'm probably on the throne.
Yeah, so even when when you post shit, you're on.
Or maybe even talking to you.
Or maybe even on the phone.
Yep. I'm on the throne or I'm, you know, in mid-flow. You'll never know. You'll never fucking know.
That's fun. Yeah, that's the thing. Yeah. We will never know.
We'll never know.
But she's just kind of like hanging around her house and she obviously doesn't have friends. And her mom was her best friend, she even says. So she has nobody. And she's in the tub.
Yeah.
We all love a good soak in the tub.
God, I love the tub.
Oh, I love the tub too.
I love it.
That was like the worst thing about our apartment in LA was we only had a shower.
Yeah.
And not a tub.
A shower.
How do you survive?
I know. But you don't.
You don't, yeah.
You don't survive.
Yeah, we didn't.
We didn't.
Nope. But she's reading this magazine, some type of girly magazine, obviously. Is that your reaction?
Yeah.
Every time you hear that sound, Jarak is taking a sip of our rosé. Yes way, rosé.
Flip flop the shit.
Can't wait to edit this.
God damn.
Oh God.
It's horrible. Ugh. I almost want to go get the fucking cab and just mix.
Ew, no. We gotta do it. This is for the episode.
Alright, it's for the episode.
We will do this. We'll do this fine. Moving on. So Ingrid is in the tub and she's reading the magazine. Like I said, oh my God, I'm totally pulling at you and repeating myself. There's a image of Taylor, who is Elizabeth Olsen, Scarlet Witch.
Scarlet Witch, yes.
A tendency to go in and out of her accent.
Oh, yeah. In different movies, what the fuck, Elizabeth? Yeah. Come on, girl.
I know you're an Olsen, but... Oh, I'm kidding. No, we love her.
Is she really an Olsen?
I think so.
She's like one of the Olsen sisters.
I'm pretty positive she is.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, yeah.
But she's non... So she's the one that didn't go batshit.
Yeah, well, she's not the... She's not... It's not a triplet.
Unless she's like a cousin.
It's a...
Sister. I don't fucking know.
It
doesn't matter.
Yeah, I'm pretty positive that she is a sister
she
because...
She does look like them.
No, exactly. Yeah. Because I think there were the twins, you know, the two.
Mary-Kate and Ashley.
Mm-hmm. It takes two, baby.
Double trouble, bitch. Best. Double trouble.
I know. Best movie ever. But yeah. And I remember knowing that there was another sister. If I'm wrong, please clock me on it. I don't know.
Clock.
We're very good journalists / podcasters.
Yeah.
But yes, we see Taylor and the article says, oh, Taylor Sloan, your new girl crush. That's what the title of the article was. So she is this Instagram photographer / influencer thing. And we get a little montage of her whole Instagram. And it's so eye roll worthy.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it's like, wow, that does look like an amazing life. Of course, we would all love. But it's like, you can tell it's already kind of fake.
Right.
But
hipster
in a good,
going down.
Yeah, in a good way.
Joshua Tree.
Yeah, Joshua Tree. Like, it looks like she has the perfect life. She's this artsy girl that lives in Venice Beach. She's married to another kind of artsy guy, but is also kind of like country in a way. I don't know.
Dude, he was hipster as fuck. Yeah. He was not country.
Yeah.
His look maybe mixed hip country or wannabe fucking hipster was country-ish. I don't know.
Yeah.
Russell, you know.
You would know better than
look.
I.
But no, dude, he was not country by any means. He was hipster.
Yeah, very, very hip. Like some of the things, like she would like quote these things out of a book.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just very fake. And they have a dog, Rothko.
Rothko.
My muse.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Baby, you're firework. Hashtag this. Hashtag that. I love that they added the hashtag bless.
I still fucking hate hashtags. I think I'm doing Twitter wrong because all matter. I do is fucking hashtag everything because I don't care.
Well, it's not. I think hashtags used to be really super the thing, but now it's. I don't know. I don't get
this
it.
This is me. I'm fucking. I've got 8 followers and 35 fucking people that I'm following. So I have no fucking idea what I'm doing.
On your Jarak Twitter.
On my Twitter. Yeah, on my Jarak. On Jarak's Twitter.
Yeah.
I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. And that is why I got on and I was like, let me practice.
On your...
And I got 8
Before
followers.
You completely destroy
Before
hours.
I fucking, botch hours.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
Ugh.
I know. I think I put it up to the mouth to take a drink, and I didn't even fucking drink it.
I think I took a bigger sip than I wanted. I think that was like a gulp. Bloop.
It's fine. Moving on.
That was for a dramatic comedic effect, and it...
Yeah, the gulp.
Yeah, my throat did not like that. Anyway, Ingrid looks up Taylor on Instagram, because in the magazine, Taylor says, I love making friends and meeting new people around the world. Because she has, Ingrid finds her Instagram and she has I can't remember the number, but it's something 24K something.
Ingrid?
No. Taylor.
Oh, followers, right?
Yeah, followers. Okay. Yeah, so she has all these followers, and that's when we get the montage when she finds her on Instagram.
Yeah.
And Ingrid starts to follow her, and just, again, here it is. It's, we're getting to see the beginning of the cycle that...
It's the obsession.
Yeah.
It's her obsession. What does she have to do to make her sleep with her?
I don't know.
It's the obsession.
Because in the beginning of the film, we saw the ending result.
Yeah.
And so now we're like, okay, we get to...
This is a new one.
Yeah, because this whole movie is... Ingrid's point of view.
Yeah.
I love that, because usually when it's like a, like with this and with you.
Right.
We get to have that experience instead of, oh, the victim, the one that's being stalked. Like, what goes through the stalker minds? Right. I don't know. This is it.
Yeah.
I love it.
Let's have a movie through the eyes of Michael Myers for once.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Right. Would you like some more Yes Way, Rosé?
Fuck.
I guess Way.
I guess way. Jesus, might as well. You bought it. Right.
What did I wear? You ought to know. You bought it.
You ought to know. You bought it.
So Ingrid is looking at the magazine again, and she has this like Manila, like, I don't know.
Sure, I guess.
Manila Luzon. I don't know. I'm thinking the drag queen. I don't know. Whatever.
I don't know. I don't remember.
It's like a lawyer's document about her mom's will, and she get...
Manila Folder, then.
Manila Folder. I was right.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if that's... Is that how Manila got her name? I don't know. Manila.
Is she a folder?
No. She's an artsy-fartsy drag queen. Well,
maybe
and
that's
fabulous.
How she got her name. She
maybe.
Did a lot of Manilas.
Maybe.
Folding.
So Ingrid gets, like, about, like, $62,000.
Yeah.
Let's say.
Interesting.
But, I don't know. Let's say $61,000. Whatever, if I'm rounding. So she decides to go to the bank or lawyer, whoever, and she gets it all in cash. What kind of bank would really allow you to do that? I don't know. And the thing is, the bank person, like, pushed her, because she has this, like, checkered JanSport backpack, and pushes it towards her. Like, he actually, like, took the money and put it in her personal backpack.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not very real, but that's just us learning. Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe banks can do it up to a certain amount. Maybe, like, I guess a million's pushing it.
Maybe.
If you asked for, like, a million in cash, they'd probably be like, it'd be like an Ozark. Is somebody harassing you? Is somebody coming after you? You know?
Oh,
remember them? Jason Bateman. They had,
yes.
Like, he was like, no, this isn't happening. It's a business.
Mm-hmm.
It's a business deal. I need cash.
Yep. Oh, yeah. So she takes the money, and then she moves to L.A.
She goes west. She goes out California way.
Go out California way. But looking for some internet. I haven't jerked off in 3 days.
Oh, my God. That is the struggle. Hashtag. Hashtag the struggle.
Oh, my God. And my first thought is, oh, great, another person moving to L.A. And it was funny when... we were out with our two friends for sushi.
Malia Tequila and Tomas.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We were talking and she's like, you know what? This many, there's like a study or whatever that says, oh, this many people move to LA, but then this many people leave.
Yeah.
Which is very true because a lot of people that we went to school with don't live in LA anymore.
No, man. Yeah. Everybody's either half of them are in New York now
or
the majority went back home.
Relatable.
Fine.
Yeah,
I mean,
not a bad thing.
No, not a bad thing at all. And I'm not saying that because LA is ridiculously expensive to live in. And the prices have went up.
Oh my God, they have.
Ridiculous, like, how they have went up.
Oh my God. Yeah, it's very hard to live in LA and people don't get that until they experience it.
Right.
And it is very, very hard.
That's what I love when we're, like, out here and we tell people, you know, yeah, we used to live in LA. And
why
did you leave? And it's like, bitch, go try it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, go out there and then you tell me why.
Yeah. Why don't you tell me why? Yeah, exactly. I hate getting that response because people can clock me right away that I'm not from the Midwest. And it's like, oh, yeah, I grew up in, you know, Cali, Los Angeles. Like, oh, my God, why did you move here?
I love that everybody in LA thought I was, like, from fucking the South.
The South. Mm. Oh, God. The guy on the bike.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
We fucking dude.
We were,
Man, I was lit.
We were at a Rite Aid after playing pool with Tomas and... So you have to tell the story because I wasn't there because I was in the Rite Aid.
She goes into Rite Aid. It's like fucking 2:30 in the morning, 3 o'clock. I don't know. It was up there. So anywho, she goes into the Rite Aid and I am a little fucking, I'm fucking drunk.
Yeah.
And I'm blitzed off my mind and I get out of the car because I'm starting to get really like car sick.
Need some air.
I need some air. So I get out, I have the door wide open and I'm just like, oh Jesus, leaning on the car. And then some fucking dude drives up on his little bicycle.
No, he doesn't even, he pedals.
Oh yeah, he pedals up on his fucking bicycle. He pedals up and he parks like semi close to the fucking car. And I'm already like kind of on an upper from this fucking... the amount of drinking that I've done.
Yeah, but then you, like your adrenaline goes up.
Yeah, and then he just parks right in front of me and I'm just immediately like, I'm ready, bitch. Let's go. But anywho, he parks and he goes, hey man, can I have $5? And I was like, nah, dude, it's 2020. I don't carry cash. I said, everything's on card now, you know? And then he was like, yeah, I feel you. What part of Arkansas are you from? And I just looked at him and I was like, I ain't from fucking Arkansas, dude. I'm from Missouri. He goes, oh yeah, man. I used to drive down there all the time. And then by that time, you came in and were like, get in the car.
Yeah, I was just like, no. This is not happening. Yeah. Get in the car.
Get in the car
right now. I know your game. Get out. But he was like, he was like a pretty boy too. Like,
dude. Well, that's right up there with those fucking fake ass homeless people that I cannot fucking stand. I hate them. I hate those fake fucking homeless people that beg for fucking money and they don't need it. Like that one who used to, he used to work at a fucking, outside of 7-Eleven, used to peddle that shit. And he'd be out there and I went in to 7-Eleven and I was like, he would be like, hey man, can I have some change? I'm like, nah, dude. And then I'd go in, I'd come out, hey man, can I have change? You already asked me. Oh yeah, right. Well, anywho, I followed him one time, not intentionally, but I followed this fucking dude and he had a key to the fucking Hollywood Tower. This motherfucker lived in the fucking Hollywood Tower. And I was like, you motherfucker.
You're not homeless.
You're not homeless by any fucking means.
Yeah.
You fucking are living in luxury compared to what the fuck I was living
in. Even if he was like couch hopping or couch surfing, whatever they call it. Like
somebody in the Hollywood Tower just allow him to fucking like, you know. Yeah.
But it's like, and
some squatter in the Hollywood Tower, that ain't possible.
I don't know. Yeah, that's, it's insane. And like that movie, Don't Be a Menace.
Oh, I love it. Because it's so
that.
True.
It's, yeah, they poke fun
so fucking
of
true.
The guy.
And he gets in his fucking...
Ferrari. I don't know, something fancy.
His, like, fucking Benz.
Yeah. So, Ingrid sees that Taylor lives in Venice Beach.
Yeah.
So, of course, that's where she goes. And then she gets a bike. She very much stalks Taylor and finds where she eats, where she shops, kind of thing.
Oh, I was supposed to meet her for lunch.
We're not there yet.
Oh, shit, yes.
Because we have to meet Dan Pinto, which is O'Shea Jackson Jr.
Ice Cube Jr.
Oh, my God, he's so cute.
Is he?
He's so adorable.
Is he fucking adorable?
Oh, my God.
He looks like his dad.
He's like...
Does that mean you have an Ice Cube crush?
No, like Ice
Cube... They're like spitting images of
each
other.
They are, but he is like what I would want Ice Cube to look like, to be like attractive.
I mean, I
guess. I was like sort of attracted to Ice Cube, but he was, but I like wasn't at the same time. But
yo, man! His, well, I can't really do a good Ice Cube, so I'm not even gonna try anymore.
His son is like what I would want Ice Cube to be. He just, he has that smile. That fucking smile.
Yeah.
He's every time he smiles, it's like, oh.
Yeah, he is adorable, isn't he?
He's just cute.
He is really cute. Pinch his cheeks and shit.
Yeah, pinch his cheeks. But
nice beard, though.
Very nice beard.
Nice beard.
His beard is on fleek.
His shit's on fleek!
Yeah. Which we'll get. Opie. Yeah, we'll get there. Sorry, dude. But she
He's like,
she's riding her bike and she sees that there's a place for rent.
Yeah.
And O'Shea, his name's Dan. I like calling him Pinto.
Pinto.
The last name is perfect, Pinto. He turns out to be the landlord of the place.
Yeah.
And we find out that he is, oh, this is just kind of like my side job.
I'm a rider.
That's a pretty good side job for someone that's trying to be in the industry. Like, we don't know how he became a landlord.
Right.
Which is fine. But it's like, as someone who, us, that knows, okay, normally.
Struggling artist.
There you go. You're either in the service industry.
Right.
It is the best industry to be in because.
Well, fuck, from what he told her the rent was.
Well, yeah.
He was like $2,200 for the next 2 months.
It was like $2,900.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're right.
I think. Yeah. Yeah.
$2,900 for the first 2 months. And then, so you paid $2,900 every 2 months.
Is that what he said?
That's what he said for the first 2 months. We don't know I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Moving forward, that's what it fucking was.
But he was like, plus security deposit,
some shit.
He wanted, like, I think first and last.
Yeah.
With the security deposit, which normally is.
I don't even think she was in a fucking one room either. I don't know what
it was. Probably very small.
Yeah.
It could have been like a
studio. We don't really get to see.
We don't see too much of her place.
That place, per se, except for the bedroom.
Yeah, she doesn't spend too much time there.
Yeah.
So, anywho, so she's like, oh, do you take cash? Oh, okay. So
you strip a thumb?
No, yeah, because he, of course, it's very questionable. Someone has, like, all this cash on hand, and he's like, are you an escort? No. Are you a drug dealer? No. Okay, hold on. Chick bag full of money. Yeah. That's very suspicious. And she said, all right, well, my mom died and she left me a bunch of money.
And he's so quick to fucking believe her ass, too. He's like, oh, man, condolences.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. Yeah.
Yeah, it's like, come on, man.
In her defense, it is true.
No, it's very true.
Yeah.
But you know what? I'm sorry. I don't trust anybody anywhere. I don't give a fuck if you're in Los Angeles. I don't give a fuck if you're in St. Louis, Texas. I'm not gonna fucking trust anything.
Exactly. We don't even answer phone calls to numbers that we don't know.
No, and that's like, how it should be.
Exactly, yeah.
Caller ID is like a thing of the past now. You don't necessarily know who the fuck's calling you anymore.
Yeah.
You know?
I love the moment. So he takes the money. And there's, like, this awkward silence, and she says, okay, well, and he says, fuck off. Okay, I get it. All right,
yeah,
cool,
I'm
out.
Love
I'm
that.
Out, I'm
yeah.
out, I'm out. And after that, he, like, instantly follows her on Instagram, which is fine. Hey, you want to find out who your tenants are, that's great.
Yeah.
But you can tell he kind of had a little, he's like, ooh, cute girl.
No, he was definitely, he was definitely at half a lift.
Oh, yeah. Oh, and we found out that he is a huge Batman fan.
Absolutely.
Because he's a screenwriter and he's got this spec script
that's a
Batman spec, something that's going to come out somehow. I don't know. You know, it's just that LA talk. Like, yeah, I got this going on. It's just like, okay, all right. All right, cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, he even has like a card. But he kind of was like misleading because... he gives her card and she's like, oh, you're a writer? Like, have you written anything that I see? And he goes, you ever see Batman? You wrote that? No, but...
No, but I am writing a spec.
Yeah, but he is like, well...
Fan film.
Yeah, well, you'll see
Let's
throughout...
Let's just be real. Everybody in this film is fucking misleading.
Thank you for just outing everything that
I'm
wanted.
Sorry. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Fuck me, right? I'm sorry. Fuck.
It's fine. God, we're... Okay. Ingrid got her apartment.
Oh, damn, this fucking white wine.
Oh my
Jesus
God.
Christ. Fuck me, right?
Rosé was a bad choice.
Rosé was a bad fucking choice. What is the alcohol content on this
bitch? Didn't even look.
I don't even see one. That's a bad sign.
That's a bad sign, guys.
I'm gonna have a bad time.
Oh my God. I totally forgot. Fuck.
What? Do tell.
Before Ingrid moved to LA, Ingrid was trying to comment... on
dude, I can relate.
Yeah. We can all relate.
Especially today.
Especially today.
Yeah, dude.
Okay, like, hold on. Let's
okay, moving on.
We gotta
get back on track. I'm sorry guys. We're fucking this wine. I need tannins.
My God.
I need tannins!
Maybe this is why all people like rosés and whites, because they hit harder?
Maybe, fuck, I don't know.
So, Ingrid sees a post that Taylor has. It's this beautiful, like, avocado toast with some other beautiful greens, and she even says, like, another day, another avocado toast. Hashtag something, whatever.
Hashtag hipster.
Yeah. Hashtag fake.
Yes.
And Ingrid does this dance where she tries to think of a comment to say to her. And it's very telling and creepy and real at the same time.
Yeah.
Because, God, what does she say? Damn, girl, that toast is good. What's your email address?
Right.
Okay. She deletes that.
Right, smart.
Oh my God, I'm such a foodie. Should we be besties? Ha 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 ha. Delete, 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 delete. He 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 he. Delete, delete, delete. He 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 he. Delete, delete, delete. And then she said, she ended up going with, oh my God, did you make that yourself?
Smart.
And Ingrid goes to a supermarket. She goes to get essentials, whatever. And Corona beer. Corona beer, I know they don't sponsor us, but don't kill us. But she, there's a lot of Corona beer in this.
They probably sponsored the movie.
I'm sure. Oh my God, I didn't even think about
that. Yeah, they probably sponsored the movie.
Yeah, that's like Sex in the City with Sky Vodka.
Right.
It was everywhere.
Yeah.
They probably sponsored the beer.
They probably sponsored
true.
The fucking movie, yeah.
Yeah. And Ingrid's at the checkout, and we see some chick who we didn't recognize, but the chick recognized Ingrid because she's on the phone and she's like, oh my God, you won't believe who I'm looking at right now. I'm looking at Ingrid Thornburn. I thought she was in an insane asylum.
I don't remember that.
Oh yeah, yeah. That's when we get more story about Ingrid's background with Charlotte. Do you remember now?
I remember Charlotte. I don't remember the chick that was all like, oh my God.
Yeah, yeah. Like,
it's taken me back to fucking, again, you, when Joe walked into the fucking party and the chick was like, oh, Joe, where's Candace? Or whatever the fuck her name was.
You've been exposed.
Hashtag.
Exposed.
Hashtag hello you.
Exposed. Oh, goddamn. So, we still get the voice of the chick saying, yeah, I thought she was in a mental institution. Who let her out? Yeah, she just went so batshit crazy. Like, her and Charlotte weren't even friends. She liked or commented on one thing on her Instagram, and Ingrid went total psycho and stalked her, and that's pretty much it.
Right.
Ingrid is doing pretty much what she's doing in the throughout the movie. She's finding someone that she thinks she could be friends with, and there you go, they're best friends.
Yeah.
It's a real thing. Just because you, like, socialize on social media, that doesn't mean that you're friends.
Yeah, you're absolutely right.
You have to be able to, like, know the difference, and Ingrid did not, and some people do not.
No, some people don't. They literally look at it like, oh yeah, we're pen pals.
Pen pals.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Okay. Like, that's what pen pals do. Jesus Christ, kid. Get comfy.
Get comfy,
dude.
All right?
You're losing the...
You're making it worse.
You're losing the blanket, bub. All right.
He doesn't care.
Oh, dude, he's adorable, though.
I know.
Anywho.
We missed our babies.
I know, man. That was the one thing about being away.
Yeah.
But,
So, yeah, that's what started the idea for Ingrid to go west, because after that scene, she was, like, in her bathroom, like, completely broken down and crying.
We've all been there.
Yeah. And then she gets a notification on her phone, and Taylor commented back, Ingrid.
Don't we all feel great, though, when that happens?
Yeah.
Dude, for real.
Of course.
It's never happened to me, but...
Okay, then why did you...
But don't we all feel wonderful?
Oh my God, when the two chicks from Rock of Love follow us on Twitter, I was like, oh my God, I feel amazing.
Right.
But anyway, Taylor comments back, LOL, I wish. I got it from something something kitchen. You definitely have to try it the next time you're in LA. That gave Ingrid the idea to move to LA.
There you go.
Thank you. I got it. So now let's get back to where we were earlier. Ingrid goes to said restaurant. Mm-hmm. And the first thing the server says is, what's your biggest emotional wound?
Cue fucking Mark Wahlberg.
Why the fuck would he say that?
Oh my god, exactly.
Like, for real.
Yeah, yeah, and she's so obviously taken aback. Like, what? Oh, that's our question of the day. It's like posted on their little neon chalkboard.
If anybody asked me that, I
would say something really, really creepy to,
I was touched.
To fuck them up.
Yeah. I was touched.
Yeah.
By your father.
Yeah, or something. And she's like, no, but he shares. And he says, mine's my relationship with my dad, yeah. And she's like, no, I'm good. And then he says, well, I think it's called like Grateful Kitchen or something.
Something.
Something very
hippie.
Hippie.
Hipster.
Yeah, I love it. I think it's fabulous.
No, it's great.
My name is Eden. How may I nourish you today?
Jesus Christ.
And Ingrid starts to ask questions. Oh, I'm supposed to meet a friend here. And she puts up a picture of Taylor on her phone.
Oh, yeah, Taylor.
Taylor Sloan. Yeah, she comes in here all the time. She was just here an hour ago. And you're supposed to meet her for lunch? And she plays it off. She's like, oh my god, I'm so stupid. I just, like, totally forgot the time. But, do you remember what she ordered?
If that's not a fucking red flag, dude.
So Ingrid orders what Taylor got, and it's some like cauliflower breaded,
it did look good,
spinach thing. It looked great. Yeah. It looked really, really tasty. But she takes a picture of it, posts it, whatever. She takes a bite and she immediately spits it out and thinks it's like horrible.
Yeah.
And then the next,
then she gets In-N-Out.
Yeah. Is it In-N-Out?
It was In-N-Out.
It was In-N-Out. That's right.
Well, we just saw her eating fries, so my assumption is she got In-N-Out.
We had In-N-Out going in, and we had In-N-Out
going out, bitch. It was good.
You really did? Like,
I fucking love
like
In-N-Out. I don't
literally
care.
Literally In-N-Out.
Anybody that fucking has a hate on In-N-Out, get the fuck out of here.
How dare you?
Yeah.
It was great. It was great. Thank
fucking
you, Tomas.
Need one in the Midwest. Yeah, Tomas.
Yeah. So Ingrid's like scarfing down fries. Like, she literally took like a handful of fries. And she's like, oh my god, I'm so starving. And we see that on Ingrid's phone, she's looking at Taylor, obviously, and Taylor takes like a selfie and says, oh, summer hair time, thanks to, like, she's pretty much like, she's a brand person, like, she uses her influence as an influencer to promote things. Mm-hmm. I mean, I got that pretty much immediately. But yeah, she got her hair done at some salon, so Ingrid goes to the same salon. And because it's not that big of a deal, but she was a brunette at first. So she went to this great California blonde. Her attire has totally changed. I'm sure she went shopping to every place that Taylor goes to.
Yeah.
Because she comes out after her hair and there's like that slow-mo of her walking. And it's like, all right, there she is. She is transformed to her fake self.
Yeah.
I think she even, bought, like, the same bag, like, same purse. It was, like, an oversized, like, clutch thing.
Yeah.
So she got that, and she starts walking down the canals of Venice.
You said that, yeah.
Yeah, which, and then the next shot, she's, like, walking by this boutique that, oh, no, Taylor's at the boutique.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, and she,
all hands on deck.
Yeah, and Ingrid fucking panics. But I just thought it was weird. Unless, you know, I lived in Venice like 10 plus years ago, and I've never seen a boutique at the canals. My dream was to own a house at the canals in Venice, but I don't think those people that live there ever leave.
Probably not.
I wouldn't.
No.
I mean, shit, there's a fucking canal,
well,
right?
Fuck, they probably make, God knows, and how expensive I'm sure they are. Fuck.
Oh my god. More than Ingrid's rent, that's for sure.
Yeah.
So Ingrid decides to, she goes, oh my god, it's totally fine. Like, it's cool. Just be cool. Just be cool. She tries to, like, try out her LA voice.
Yeah.
And she goes into the boutique and it is, like, totally awkward.
Oh, dude, she totally starts talking like me. Fuck, shit, bitch, cunt, fuck this, fuck it. Hey, how are you? You know?
Oh my god, that's so real.
God damn it.
So she gets Taylor's attention kind of by accident by, like, knocking over some shit, and Ingrid, like, pulls it off by just trying to act natural.
Yeah.
And Ingrid, like, picks up this book. She doesn't even look at it, really. She's like, oh my, oh my god, great. Oh my god, I think I'm gonna buy it.
Yeah. She walks out of the store.
She walks out of the fucking store, and the clerk's like, excuse me, miss, you gotta buy that. And she goes like, oh,
I'll be right out.
Yeah. Trying to, like, pull it off, like, oh, she had someone outside for her, and she bought the book, and that was it. That was,
right,
like, just the encounter. And Taylor was just looking at her like,
fuck is your deal, bitch?
Fuck is going on? But yeah, she didn't really pay too much mind to it. So Ingrid needs a way to get in with her.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it's not even, like, to be in her circle. Like, she is determined to be her, like, BFF.
Yeah.
Like, they want, she wants to have, like, the matching necklaces with the heart that's, like, chopped in the middle that all of us did in, like, the fifth grade. We had necklaces with our BFFs. And she already knows where Taylor lives.
Yeah.
Like, fucking crazy. I don't know if, like, Taylor put that out there or not, like, where she lives.
No.
I think, oh, you know what? Ingrid just, like, knew all of her pictures from Instagram so well that she was able to figure out where her house is, I think. And she knows that she has a dog.
Yeah.
So she breaks, pretty much, like, breaks into Taylor's house because Taylor and her husband, Ezra.
Ezra.
Ezra. Oh, my God. That is such an eye roll name.
Right. Ezra.
They're going out, and Ingrid fucking steals Rothko.
Yeah.
And I know you were, like, your reaction to that was like,
dude, not for real, though. It's like, number one, shame on them for leaving their fucking window wide the fuck open. Number fucking two, the dog leaps up and she catches it. So the people are automatically going, oh, he must have jumped out of the window. That tiny fucking dog jumped out of the fucking window, you dumbasses. No fucking way. That's not what happened.
Somebody
clearly fucking stole the goddamn dog because why? You left the fucking window wide the fuck open. What the fuck, you hippie fucks? You don't know, like, Jesus Christ. Oh, people, we gotta trust everybody. Fuck no, dude, that's what happens. Your dog gets stolen. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Your turn.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. Anyway.
Yeah.
Ingrid.
But no, for real, it's like, you're dumb. Don't leave your fucking window wide the fuck open.
Hashtag.
Lock the bitch.
Hashtag, you're dumb.
Hashtag, you're dumb. Hashtag, locks.
Or just close.
Closed.
Just close the damn windows.
Yeah. Hashtag, close the fucking windows. Turn on the air.
Turn on the
fucking air.
Give your dog some air.
Give your dog some fucking air.
Yeah, so Ingrid has Rothko as her hostage, yeah, and she finds that Taylor and Ezra are looking for Rothko. They mm-hmm. put signs up all over Venice, and she calls the number that they left, and she didn't want them to come to her. She's like, oh, let me come to you. Yeah, I'll be right over. And then Ezra's like, wait, don't you need the address? And she's like, oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Ugh, totally. Yeah, totally. Let me get a pen. Doesn't get a pen.
She just knows. Like, yeah.
Fucking creepy.
Fucking, she's a nut, dude.
Yeah, and then they finally meet.
Yep.
And Ingrid is the hero.
Right.
They are just, of course. I mean, anyone that would bring your dog back, you'd be like, oh, my God.
Thank you.
So much. We've been missing him and blah, blah, blah. And they try to, like, give her money because they did say that there was, like, a cash reward. And she's like, no, I don't need it. Rothko was just an amazing dog. I'm just happy. He was great company, and I'm just glad he's back home. And Ezra has the idea, well, you know what? We are cooking dinner. Come stay for dinner.
Wrong, you fucking idiot. You did it again. Not only did you leave the fucking window open, but you invite a complete fucking stranger over for fucking dinner. This isn't 1947 anymore, dude. Okay? Yeah. This is the time of creep fucking people. And if you can't think that, shame on you.
Yeah, shame on them.
Shame on fucking you. This is what you get.
Spoiler.
Moving on.
So, Ingrid goes into the house and she is just so amazed because, of course, their house looks cute. It's adorable.
Hipster.
Very. And even Ezra's like, I'm so sorry. We haven't had time to go shopping because we've been so, like, scared of Rothko and, you know, what's been happening with him. He has this little weird, like, blowtorch and starts, like...
Yeah, I didn't get that.
Yeah.
I guess that's a cooking thing.
It's some type of cooking tool. I know they use it for, like, creme brulee. Yeah. Where they try to, like, burn the top crust thing.
Yeah.
Ingrid takes a sip of whatever drink concoction they make and she's like... Oh, fuck, this is so fucking good.
Fuck.
Yeah, she's like, fuck me. Fuck me, this is amazing. And they're like, oh, yeah, I'm sorry. It's just so not, like, what we usually do.
Yeah.
Because we've just been so devastated over, like, Rothko and, yeah. Oh, yeah, like I said, they totally come off as, like, the perfect L.A. couple.
Yeah.
The dinner's amazing. Everything tastes great. And... Ingrid, like, attempts to have, like, the L.A. lingo. She just says, like, totally a lot.
Yeah.
Which...
Like... There you go.
Oh, there we go. Oh, my God! Good
on you, Callie. You did it.
I've been exposed.
All right. Moving.
True. Oh, so Ingrid goes into the bathroom.
Yeah.
And she just starts to take pictures of every single thing they have in that bathroom.
Yeah.
That's when, like, this movie does a really great thing of, like, making you root for Ingrid, but mm-hmm. also puts you back in reality. Like, okay, hold on. There's something wrong with her. What she's doing is really bad.
Yeah.
And Ingrid starts to, like, very, like, slyly, like, oh, so what do you guys do for money?
Right.
So sly. Like, that's an odd question to ask people that you just met.
Right.
You know?
What do you guys do for money?
Yeah. Taylor is a photographer, and she gets paid to post on her Instagram yeah. and mention people that are in, you know, business, and that's her
Ezra
thing.
Ezra doesn't really do anything.
He doesn't do anything, but he's an artist.
Right.
He's such a talented artist.
Yeah, he's so talented. Tell me what his fucking art is.
Yeah, so his art is pretty much, like... hashtags or slogans printed on somebody else's art.
Right. I might as well fucking frame the shit on my toilet paper and fucking say, there it is.
Yeah.
Pure art for you.
Like, one of them... Ingrid ended up buying one of his art.
Right.
One of his...
He upsold the fuck out of it.
Yeah. Well, they were just so...
How much is it? How much? 1,200.
At first there was, I heard a little bit of an 800, 1,200.
Yeah.
You guys take cash. And of course they love her now because.
She just paid $1,200.
Yeah. She bought, it was a painting of
horses.
Beautiful painting. And then Ezra just printed squad goals.
Yeah, how stupid.
On it.
Let shit all over the fucking painting. Why not?
Legendary.
Yeah.
Iconic. If you will.
Very fucking, what's his name? Andy Warhol.
I think he probably thinks himself as an Andy Warhol
yeah.
of this time.
Fucking piece of shit.
Yeah, it didn't work. But they didn't, like, the movie didn't try to convince us that it worked. The movie was like, yeah, you guys know this is bullshit. This is terrible.
Right, this is bullshit.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, and we don't really get too much background about Ezra, I think. That he just probably just doesn't work, and she probably makes most of the money.
Yeah,
that's what my guess was.
Yeah,
and she's
that's why
just
he cooks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so she buys the art, Ingrid, and they are opening a bottle of champagne. And to Ingrid, rescuer of dogs, new friend, and patron of the arts.
Yeah.
So Ingrid thinks, okay, I'm in.
Yeah,
I'm so in. Ingrid finds, of course, another way to get in. I can't remember how it happened, but Taylor, she remembered that she had to do something, drop off some type of something at their, oh, they have another house at Joshua Tree.
Joshua Tree, yeah.
I have never been to Joshua Tree. I guess that makes me a bad Angeleno, maybe. I don't know. But I know a lot of people that would go there. That's like a place I think you would go when you want to, like, camp, but still not camp.
Like, do a lot of Burning Man's happen in fucking Joshua
Probably.
Tree?
Probably. Yeah. I do kind of see Joshua Tree as, like, a Burning Man, but without the festival, right. And just the, yeah, without the bands.
Yeah.
Ingrid's like, oh, she has a truck. No, she doesn't.
My ass.
Yeah. She knows that Dan Pinto
has a truck.
Pinto has the truck, and she entices Dan to use the truck.
And how fucking stupid of him.
Well, she's like, she says, oh, she'll read for Catwoman.
You're right.
It's like, yeah, no, I can't do it because my spec script, we're doing a table read, and Catwoman just bailed, so why don't you just play Catwoman?
I'm gonna tell you right fucking now, folks. Okay. I would never, ever, 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 ever give my fucking truck to some fucking girl that I just met. I don't give a flying fuck who you are.
It's a movie.
I don't care if you're Shakira, okay? Yeah, I said it.
Oh my God.
I don't
God.
Care if Shakira came to this fucking house and said,
your first wife?
My first wife. If she came to our fucking house and said, truck, I need a truck. I'd be like, bitch, walk. Because it ain't happening. I ain't giving you my fucking truck. Go ahead. Continue.
Okay. Point noted.
Point noted. That's dumb. Dudes, if you give your fucking vehicle to somebody, to some girl, to anybody.
Especially a truck.
Especially a fucking truck, and they're expensive as shit. You're dumb.
Hashtag, you're dumb.
Hashtag, you're dumb.
So Taylor and Ingrid go on a road trip.
Yeah.
It's so much fun. Taylor, like, something happened. Something happens where Ingrid gets distracted.
Oh, yeah. She was just staring at her.
She was just staring at Taylor.
She was just fucking staring at her.
And the glove compartment opens up. Yeah. And in the glove compartment, there's what we're supposed to be told is a gun.
Right.
And a bunch of vials of cocaine.
Yeah. You give your truck to some random stranger with a fuckload of cocaine.
When you know you have drugs and a questionable firearm.
Dumb.
Yeah.
Hashtag.
Cool. Great. And Ingrid's like, oh no, this isn't mine. She ends up just saying that.
My boyfriend, Dan.
Yeah, It's my boyfriend, Dan. Like, we just started dating and some engine light went on. So they had to stop at some place to fix the car. And I don't know. Just Taylor, she's
Fucking brat.
No, not that she's a brat. She is very misleading with the way she talks to Ingrid. And it's just very fake. She's like, oh my God, I can't believe you didn't tell me that you had a boyfriend. Bitch, you just met.
Yeah.
How long? I don't know how long Joshua Tree is from LA, but is that enough time to talk about your life story?
Right. I had no idea you had a boyfriend, Ingrid. Well, what pissed me off...
would you ever go in an Uber and start asking your Uber driver, personal
shit? I'm gonna do
shit?
It now.
You're gonna do
I'm gonna
it
do now. It now. The next fucking Uber we get, I'm gonna be like, oh my God, you're married? You never told me that, Trevor.
Yeah, which I've only Ubered once. And that was in LA, because my mom and I didn't have a car.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, to go see my cousin.
I'm gonna do it.
I sat in the front. I was like, hey, what's up? He was nice.
I don't think I don't think Uber drivers are against people sitting in the front, believe it or not.
Yeah.
I'd probably sit in the back.
I can't.
But again, I don't know if I would because it would take me back to the bone collector and I'd get all freaked out and think that the locks in the back are razor blades. Have you not seen the bone collector?
I don't think so.
Okay, remedying it.
All right. I can't with you.
Did I ruin it?
No, you did not. But I did interrupt you about something you were about to say.
I don't remember, so that's not important.
All right, not important. Moving on.
There's not enough wine. We ran out.
No, that was enough wine.
Okay.
For the now.
I'll have the rest.
No!
Okay.
Mine.
Here, let me pour it in your mouth.
So since the car is getting, fixed, they decide, oh, hey, let's make a night of it. But Ingrid is supposed to be at the table read because I didn't mention earlier that the table read is that day.
Right.
That evening, whatever. And
she's reading as Catwoman.
Yeah. Pinto keeps texting her hey, where you at?
The fuck are you, bitch?
Where the fuck are you? Answer your phone. And the funny thing is, like, I didn't really see that he tried calling her.
He did.
He did? Yeah, okay, he didn't remember that.
She had a couple missed calls.
Okay, but she's having the best time with her new best friend. Mm. And they end up, like, doing the coke.
They did all the coke.
All the snow on top of the mountain. And
the Himalayas was dusted.
They were cut very, very clean. And very smooth. So Taylor wants to go dancing. Let's go dancing. Of course, when you're on coke, you want to go dance.
Yeah.
So I've heard. Get out.
I'm sorry.
So they're at this, like, Mexican restaurant, and they're like, they're taking shots too. They're doing right. Like shots of tequila. They're dancing.
Corona.
More coronas.
More coronas.
Yes, coronas all around.
Made by women for women. Coronas.
Is that the slogan?
No.
Oh.
That was some guy I drank with at the Hollywood Tower. He said he made. No, I'm sorry. He made tequila. For women, by women.
Ooh, sexy.
It was fucking bizarre.
You've told me that.
I have. Yeah. We'll save that for another day.
Save that for another day. We've told a lot of good stories so far.
Yeah.
And the thing is, like, Taylor is giving Ingrid these compliments that it's not... I'm going to be, like, devil's advocate here with this movie because, absolutely. Of course, she doesn't know who Ingrid is.
No.
Ingrid is very impressionable. Mm-hmm. Like, she really takes what you say to heart.
Yeah.
And the typical, I'm sure it's like that everywhere, but I don't know. I'm going to say more like in LA. It's just like, oh my God, I love you. You're the best. Oh my God. You're like a lifesaver.
Yeah.
She says
for the TikTok.
Yeah. I love you. You're the best. You're so funny. And so like just giving her all these compliments, which a normal person would be like, stop.
Yeah.
But Ingrid is taking this to heart. Like, oh my God, we are legit becoming besties right now. It gave Ingrid false hope that that's what's going to happen in the end. And they're going to walk
down the aisle.
Down the aisle and just be happy forever. Oh, it's so funny. When we were in LA, I don't know if I noticed it more because I've been away from it. And then also, again, bringing up you, the show.
Me? What show?
You.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Jesus.
My Goldblum, whatever, is your you.
My Goldberg.
Gold, whatever. Joe, the second season when, oh, my God, if you haven't seen You yet.
Turn around. Turn around immediately.
Well, yeah. Earmuffs.
Earmuffs, kids.
The second season when he moves to L.A. and he's doing that inner dialogue of like mocking people. It was him walking down some popular street of all these people doing like selfies and trying to take the perfect picture.
Yeah.
This trip, I really noticed that.
Yeah, I wanted to, that's why in one of our fucking pictures when I was kissing the me thing, that's why I was making fun of. I was making fun of all the fucking girls at fucking...
Yeah, if you missed our Instagram stories, I saved a couple pictures and I'll like actually make them a post so you can see that.
I couldn't believe the amount of fucking people that were doing that and it was so ridiculous.
Yeah, and in the movie, Taylor is trying to, the mechanic... She wants him to take a picture.
I felt so bad for him.
That poor man.
Yeah. Especially when she was like, get lower. And he was like, on the floor?
Yeah.
And of course, the floor was the fucking dirt.
The fucking dirt.
And the dust desert of Joshua Tree where they fucking were.
I think in Taylor's mind, she's like, look, I am pretty much endorsing your company. So you're going to want...
I hate those fucking type of people, though.
Yeah.
For real.
But the thing is, like,
It's like going to fucking McDonald's and saying, hey, I just paid you for a fucking Big Mac, so come over here and fucking wipe my ass.
Yeah. Sure.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm right.
Cool.
Thank you.
All right.
Good.
Moving on.
All right.
But yeah, she's, like, trying to get the perfect picture, but it's Ingrid.
Right.
Ingrid is so excited.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. She is so excited that
her pants were wet.
They were soaked.
Yeah. See the drip.
Yeah. Taylor ended up posting it and tagging Ingrid, she got so excited that she printed the fucking Instagram picture.
Right.
It was like our wedding. We printed a couple, like, it was my mom. She printed a bunch of pictures of us, and some of them were from Instagram, and you can even, like, see the Instagram label and the amount of people that liked it. Yeah. And so it was, yeah, very that.
Cute.
Yeah, very adorable. Let's see. Oh, when they finally leave Joshua Tree, they're singing that song, I can never find another lover.
More precious than you.
More precious than you.
Girl, out there, I can be a sexy like your mother.
Sexy like your mother.
I don't know. I forgot the word. You are my everything. My everything.
Oh, my life.
I'm precious than what I am. You. Well, I thank God that I finally found you.
But watching Ingrid sing this
was essentially how I sounded.
No, her look.
Oh, excuse me.
She was completely Ingrid's driving. She's looking at Taylor, and her face is so insane because she's like singing it to Taylor, really.
Yeah.
Like, prayed for someone like you. I hope you feel. And she's even like starting to like cry, bitch. Like, bitch.
Like, Jesus Christ, we were in LA. Fuck.
I know.
She's starting to cry, bitch.
My LA is showing. And she's like, I pray for someone like you. I totally cry.
God damn it, I lost my voice in LA.
I know, you really did. He was screaming on. We went to Universal and Disneyland, which was so much fun. But you were screaming on all the damn rides.
Hey, dude.
Butterbeer was a bad choice!
Butterbeer was
Harry!
I hope somebody fucking YouTubed that shit. Somebody recorded that bitch.
Yeah, someone recorded us on that kitty
ride,
and you were screaming the house down.
Damn it, I hope.
I can't wait to see that on YouTube.
I hope I find. I hope they're big YouTubers. Yeah. Moving on.
Yeah. Weird bearded man screams like a girl on the Griffin Kitty roller coaster at Universal Studios Hollywood.
Yeah.
God damn it. That's it. That's what it's going to be.
Fucking famous.
Oh my God.
I'm going to be better than the fucking Chewbacca mom.
Oh, the Chewbacca mom.
Moving on.
God. So Ingrid is so into singing to Taylor that they hit some side.
It's like a median or something?
Yeah. Yeah. Like a divider?
Yeah, a divider, I think.
Yeah, she scrapes up the truck really bad. And then Taylor is like, they're looking at the damage. She's like, you know what? I bet you can just like buff it out and you won't even notice.
Right.
It's a fucking crazy.
Dude,
like,
it was big. Whoops.
It was like fucking Freddy Krueger keyed the truck.
Yeah.
That's what it was.
Yeah. Massive.
So Ingrid drops off Taylor and she's just like, Ingrid is so, it was like they came back from their honeymoon.
Right.
She was glowing. Mm-hmm. But then she went back to Pinto. The cops were there.
Yeah, he called the cops.
Yeah, she got like dropped back down to reality.
Fucking did. Somebody stole his fucking truck that he didn't know and he gave his truck away. Yeah, like an idiot. Up.
I keep skipping. Well, the thing is, like, I'm fighting between my notes and the stuff that we're saying organically.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. It's not you. It's us. It's not you, it's us. Maybe notes was a bad choice. No, it's not.
Notes was a bad choice.
But before they were driving home, Ingrid and Taylor, when they were at Taylor's Joshua Tree house, they were like, they were sitting down.
This is important.
Yes, this is very, very important. And there's a house next door.
Right.
It's for sale. Taylor opens up to Ingrid and says, can I tell you a secret?
Yeah.
I have this dream that Ezra and I, like, buy the place next door and we turn it into, like, a boutique/hotel and we're going to call it Desert Door.
Oh my God, that's so cool.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah, it's named after this book that I'm obsessed with.
Oh my God, where can I get it?
Ingrid already got it.
Oh.
We didn't even mention that either.
Fuck. What's it called?
I can't remember. It's like the deer something.
The deer door.
The deer door? No, yeah, something like not. That. I wanted to write it down, but I did not.
Sorry, it's not important.
No, I mean, I guess. Well, on Taylor's Instagram, she like quotes this book a lot and this writer, and we'll see later. But that's what she wants to name her boutique / hotel, Desert Door.
Desert Door.
It's so perfect for Joshua Tree because it's a desert. So to Ingrid, that's a big deal because she said, can I tell you a secret? Don't tell Azra. Like, it's clear that Azra has no idea about this plan.
Yeah.
So there's that. And I think also, like, Ingrid really, she fed Taylor's ego because Taylor will, like, play, like, both of them, like, Azra and Taylor, they act like, oh, we're not that great. We're really not that great.
Right.
But Ingrid's like, oh my God, you guys are so talented. You guys are so amazing. Like, you're perfect.
Yeah.
She calls Taylor perfect. And I think that's why Taylor kept Ingrid around because she fed her fucking ego.
Yeah.
That's what I think. Do you think that?
I think that.
Okay. Thank you for agreeing with me. Yeah. And then Taylor even said, oh, Ingrid, you're a really good friend. So she said it. She said the word friend.
Yeah.
Ingrid is going to take that fucking personal.
Right.
You know? But to some people, that word friend gets thrown around.
Right. You're a really good friend. We're the best.
Yeah, you're the best. You're the best. But see, again, this is where I can see it from both sides. Like, Ingrid's going to take that serious, but very serious.
Right.
Taylor shouldn't be throwing the word friend around.
Right.
But it happens all the time.
Yeah.
And there are people that just don't take it serious like Ingrid or even serious at all. It's just like, okay, yeah, cool, fine, we're friends because we see each other on occasion or whatnot. Yeah. So the word friend
gets thrown.
It gets thrown. And Taylor did mention on their road trip about her brother. It's like a younger brother. She kind of plays like, yeah, he got really bad into drugs, but he was in rehab and he's so talented and he's just such a whatever other fancy word she puts in. So we do get, he does get mentioned.
Her brother. Yes.
Yeah. So we don't know if that's, oh, just kind of like for conversation or
if he's coming.
If he's actually going to be coming. Oh, this movie kind of gave me also a little bit of a Cable Guy vibes.
Yes.
Yeah. You said I'm your friend?
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes, I'm glad I didn't skip that note.
Okay.
Very Cable Guy.
Very much so.
Mm-hmm.
This one goes down. Jefferson Airplane. When the treaty said to be light. Alright.
Couldn't stop him.
Sorry, I just blew up the mic.
So, yeah, Dan's really, really pissed about the car, and he shoos the cops away.
Shoos the cops.
Yeah, so the good thing is the cops.
Oh, because she said, sorry, we did all your cocaine.
Yeah.
It was the officer's thanks.
Yeah, thanks, we're fine. Because, yeah, he had fucking cocaine in his fucking...
Like an idiot, and he gave it to mm-hmm. somebody that he doesn't fucking know.
Exactly.
Hello.
Hashtag dumb.
Hashtag you're dumb.
That's what it was.
Yeah.
Hashtag you're dumb.
So she was, like, kind of able to talk him out of really being mad, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's playing him. So Ingrid goes to some party where Taylor is, and she notices a new car is there.
Yeah.
And she asks, like, oh, whose car is that outside? Turns out...
it's my brother, Nikki.
It's her younger brother, Nikki, who is Billy Magnuson.
Magnuson.
What was he in that we looked?
Quite a name. Into the Woods.
Into the Woods. Yeah, he was Rapunzel's...
Prince. Yeah.
He's a singer. I totally forgot.
Agony! Oh, sorry.
He doesn't sing Agony.
He does.
No, he doesn't.
He does.
Rapunzel's Prince?
They both sing Agony.
Thank you for spitting on me.
You're welcome.
But hold up. It's not...
It's a duet between the princes. Agony.
Those aren't the only two princes, though.
Yes. Are we gonna fight?
I'm not gonna
Are
fight.
Are we gonna fucking fist and cuffs this shit?
No, we're not.
I'm ready.
I am not at Into the Woods.
Nor am I.
Stan, but I...
But I know that that is a fucking duet between the princes.
Yeah, but I feel like that Rapunzel's prince didn't have that big of a role. I thought that there were three princes.
No.
No?
No, it's
I'm
the
wrong.
Two.
I know I'm wrong.
It's the two because it's what's his fuck? It's Kirk, the
oh,
new Kirk.
One of the Chris's.
Yeah, the Chris Evans.
Pine.
Oh, Pine.
Chris Pine.
Right. Evans is Thor.
The Pine.
Chris Pine tree.
Pine scent.
Yes. Pine. And then it's
you're right.
This fucking kid.
You're
right.
Right.
Yeah.
You're right.
Thank you.
I've only seen the Into the Woods movie, like...
I've only seen it once.
I know. Well, we saw it in theaters, and I bought it on DVD, and it, like... We just never watch it.
No.
But... And I've only seen, like... I don't know Into the Woods.
The Last Midnight is the only thing worth
I sang watching. That song.
Of course you did.
For roles and readings.
There you go.
Yeah, my character arc only had, like, two songs.
Yeah.
So I picked, that was Sloman's. I was like, hey, like what, I don't know what other song to sing. These were my ideas. And he liked Last Midnight. And that was fun. I'm not a,
it's a great song.
I don't sing too many like Sondheim stuff.
Yeah.
But that was fun.
It's a great song.
Yeah, it was cool.
It would be perfect for you.
Yeah. Tomas. Oh my God. Oh, I'm just thinking, Tomas, he, for my one song with the phone cord.
Oh yeah.
Gaby Baby was my Guido.
That's right.
But for our final, like we had to like do a final performance kind of thing, just like for the grade, Gaby Baby wasn't there. And then I had to get Tomas to be my Guido. And it was really weird because his girlfriend at the time, or sort of still, anyway, was there. And
yeah.
My job was to pretty much seduce him and have phone sex with him. It was very, very awkward. Anywho, so Nikki is there and he is this totally LA dude.
Dude, he was annoying as fuck.
Very
annoying. I hated that character so much.
He reminded me of this one guy I was in an audition with. It was like we had to do like an improv like party scene.
Yeah.
And he was just hamming the shit out of it. And he just stole the light from everybody. And that's, I think, Nikki's character. He thinks he's the best. He knows
he's
the best.
The best, yeah.
And his life and his stories are all that matters and nobody else matters. Immediately, Ingrid hates him.
And Ezra hates him.
Ezra hates him too, yes. We do,
yeah.
We do learn that. Nikki calls her Olga.
Yeah.
Ingrid. Olga? Oh, Olga.
Oh, hi, Olga.
Olga, the whole time.
My favorite thing was that he just randomly snapped a picture of her, like, right away.
Yeah.
It was so fucking weird. He just goes, hey! And then he just snaps a picture.
Yeah. And this is what gave me the rosé idea.
Yeah.
Nikki and Taylor were just, like, talking whatever, and Ingrid broke up the conversation. Like, hey, Taylor, I brought rosé! Yeah. Oh my God, this is a really good bottle. Like, yeah, I know you like it. And yeah, so the night just goes on and it's pretty much just Nikki just talking.
Yeah,
the whole time. Who is, yeah, it's pretty much, he's just a bullshitter.
Yeah.
And you could just see Ezra just like rolling his eyes and just not into it.
And he leaves.
He leaves and Taylor goes, honey, could you get another bottle? He goes, oh, sure. And another brother. All right, yeah, cool.
And another brother.
Yeah, I didn't catch that.
Yeah.
Until later, but he clearly doesn't like it. And like Taylor kind of gave him the eye, like she like gave him the eyes of like
shut the fuck up,
kind of like my mom's eyes.
Oh wow, yeah.
You know she gets mad, like don't say that.
Are you serious?
Don't you ever. So Nikki starts to tell this story about how he was like going like abroad or something. Even like Ezra says, oh yeah, I'll be back, but I can't wait to hear more like racist
oh,
jokes.
Oh, your racist
yeah.
Yeah, story.
Racist story. Yeah, it's great. Nikki met some other Instagram person who has like a million plus followers.
Yeah. Harley Chung.
Yeah, Harley Chung. And Taylor was the one like, oh my God, she has like, she's so big on Instagram.
Like
she has like 3 million followers. He's like, yeah, well, I met her and hooked up with her.
Yeah.
And she invited Nikki to go to a, like a billionaire's house that she's like house sitting and invites Taylor to go to meet her, and Ingrid's like, ha, 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 oh my God, that sounds great, but remember, you can't do that because we have plans. What was it? They had plans to go to a launch party. It was called like something, oh, Little Dough.
Yeah.
I think it was like a hat company or something, and Ingrid said that she got them on the list, and he was like, oh my God, yeah, I forgot. You know what? Do you mind if I just if I bail, I don't get time to, like, spend with Nikki really a lot, and Ingrid is pressed.
Right.
She is so mad. And of course, she plays it off, like, oh, yeah, of course, I can just get Dan to go. He loves that stuff. And Nikki calls Dan. Oh, is Dan your imaginary boyfriend?
Right.
Oh, my God, you're so funny. Yeah, he's totally real. But what ended up happening, so Ingrid's home alone.
Yeah.
Checking her phone, and she sees on Taylor's Instagram that she's at the Little Doe launch party that Ingrid did whatever she did to get them in.
Right.
So she's obviously pissed. She's pissed. I would, you know what?
But she was in the VIP area.
She was in the VIP area, which I guess Ingrid did not get them on.
Right.
So I guess Ingrid was just able to get them as, like, a guest, mm-hmm. but not VIP. So Ingrid goes to the party and goes into their VIP area. And Taylor's like, oh, my God, you're here. Yeah, this is so last minute. Harley's, like, blah, 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 like, had just some extra VIP passes. So, yeah, we just came here totally random.
Yeah. Bitch.
So LA! I would have been pissed.
Yeah.
I hate that shit. Anywho, because Ingrid was in the VIP area, the bouncer, door guy, whatever, is like, he just like randomly shows up.
Are you on the list?
Are you on the list? Yeah, I'm on the list, of course. Ingrid, Farmer.
That's not on my list.
Yeah, she wasn't on the list for the VIP. Taylor Trott, like, she half-assedly, like, tries to be like, oh,
she's with us.
She's with us. And like, nope, I'm on the list. Can't go in. But Ingrid stays, I guess, wherever the non-VIP people were, and just, like, watched them.
Yeah.
And they're, like, you know, posting all these photos and making it, you know, perfect, like, Instagram-worthy. And it's just getting really, really bad. So, oh, and Taylor invites Ingrid to the house that Harley's house sitting. This really nice party. You can see, like, on Harley's face and, like, Nikki's face, it's like, oh my God. Like, it's weird. Like, they can kind of see Ingrid for who she is. And he's like, oh my God, like, you should invite Dan. Mm. I mean, he's not your imaginary boyfriend, right? Like, even Taylor and Ezra were saying, they were the ones that called him imaginary.
Imaginary, yeah.
Yeah, and Nikki just, like, totally, like...
Called it out.
And Taylor's like, well, no, we didn't really say that. We were just saying that we never see him and whatnot. So Ingrid's like, fuck, I gotta bring this guy. So she tries to convince Dan to go to the party. And she does it by giving him a gift that apparently he already had, like, this many years ago. And they go out to dinner. And, yeah, she, like... At first, it, like, kind of wasn't a date, but she kind of, like, upped the ante. Like, okay, like, you can see it in her eyes, like, she has a motive for this.
Right.
Which we all know as an audience, but he doesn't know. Like, when is she going to ask him, can you come to this party? But it, like, goes up a notch where she just, all right, I just have to get physical with this guy.
Yeah.
And they start making out the restaurant, and then they're at his place, and he's on the bed, like half naked.
And she does that stupid fucking, like, striptease.
It wasn't really a striptease. She dressed up, quote,
As Catwoman.
It was pretty much, like, a Party City cat mask. She was wearing this, like, cropped Catwoman t-shirt and her, like, booty...
She was wearing granny panties.
They weren't granny... No, they were not granny panties.
Oh, were they not?
No, they were, like booty short... style panties where see cheeks.
Oh, okay.
But she was trying really hard to, like, be Catwoman and be, like, super sexy. She just was being really literal with it.
She's like,
ram.
Yeah. And he found that sexy.
He found it so sexy.
Yeah.
He was so into it. And then when she finally got on top of him, she did the Batman Returns thing when she licked Pinto from chin to forehead.
Yeah.
And, God, what did she say? She said something like, he asked
her. He said, say Gotham needs you.
Yes. Yeah. Gotham needs you. Something like that. And she was, like, calling him Bruce.
Oh, God, she was calling him Bruce.
He was so into it.
It was so fucking weird.
It was really weird, but it was supposed to be weird. So they're in post-coitus, And you can tell she's like, okay, let's have, like, she mapped this whole thing in her mind. Like, okay, I'm going to cuddle with him. I'm going to try to be, like, super cute. And, oh, by the way, I have some friends. They're having some pool party or whatever. Do you want to come?
Yeah, babe.
And he's so like, yeah, of course. Like, he's, what's that word called? Like, he's, like, already whipped.
Yeah.
Is that?
He's pussy whipped.
Yeah, something like that. Or he didn't, yeah. You can tell he's
a pussy trap. We're a trap with a pussy.
Yeah, but he, like, I don't know. You can tell that he, like, legit likes her.
No, he does.
I feel like she actually shows her somewhat real personality with him more than anyone else.
Yeah.
So he's like the character that keeps us on her side.
Yeah, exactly. I think,
for sure. So they're about to go to the party and Ingrid like totally dresses him up, attempts to dress him up as like an LA guy, which is so not Pinto. He's Batman t-shirt, or he wears Laker gear with his like LA baseball hat, whatever. He's just chill.
Yeah.
But he's wearing, like, this Hawaiian button-down that he has to button all the way up.
Right.
This
weird
fedora thing, like Jason Mraz hat. And he's, like, very uncomfortable. And Ingrid says, oh, wait, before we go in, I kind of already told them that you're my boyfriend. Can you just, like...
Bet.
Yeah. And he was 4. He was like, oh, come on. Yeah.
All right, baby. I'll be your boyfriend.
All right, baby. I'll be your boyfriend. Be super... And he was, like, being really cute. And yeah. Like, giving her kisses, and she's like, can you just not do that?
Yeah.
Can you just stop? You're just a prop. Ingrid tries to tell Dan, like, don't talk to Nikki. He's a drug addict. He's mean. He hates me. Don't like him.
Yeah.
And Dan, like, kind of, like, throughout the party, like, he kind of tries to, like, call her out. Like, why are you acting like this?
Right.
Like, Ingrid puts on her facade that she puts out for Taylor. Oh my god. It gets like a little darker. Ezra's like, oh my god, I was saying soapbox, and I wrote down Ezra is on his soapbox.
Right.
He's talking about an artist and kind of like calling him out for being, just kind of like calling him out for being like a sellout or something like that. And then Nikki kind of says, well, wait, what about your art? Doesn't your art kind of do the same thing as the other person? And Ezra's just, no, that's not what I'm saying. Like, Taylor, like, babe, back me up. And Taylor's face, that reaction was really, really good. Because you can tell that she is very torn between her brother and her husband. Because he's a drug addict. He constantly asks for money from her. And she just...
gives.
She enables him. She pretty much just does whatever because she loves him and she believes in him and kind of like pushes off like who he really is. Like he is a horrible person.
Yeah.
But he's the type of character as well where you like you hate him but you like him at the same time. Like he's supposed to be like betrayed as the villain, but he's not wrong.
Who, Nikki like, or the
yeah, Nikki.
Okay.
Yeah, through like because we're watching this movie through Ingrid's point of view.
Yeah.
Nikki's the enemy.
Right.
He's the villain. Taylor just doesn't say really much. She's like, well, I can kind of see what Nikki's saying, but And Ezra gets mad and he leaves. And Nikki's like, he also like walks behind Ingrid.
Oh, he looks at her phone.
He looks at her phone and sees her her little passcode to get on her phone. And something, and also you kind of get the idea that Dan and Nikki, like, they hit it off. Because when they met, I didn't say this, like, oh my god, you're real, hey.
Yeah. You're like Batman, I hear.
Yeah, because Taylor tells Nikki everything. Oh, I heard you're like obsessed with Batman. Because Ingrid's like, please don't talk about Batman. Don't talk about anything comic book. Just be, quote, quote, normal, which is fake. But he likes Batman too, Nikki. So they hit it off and they talk a lot. And Dan's like, why do you hate Nikki so much? Like, he's so cool.
Yeah.
She's like, trust me. He's bad. He's a horrible person. So, yeah, Ezra leaves. And Taylor and the Harley Chung chick, they left too to probably like make more drinks or whatever. And Ingrid kind of like sneaks where they are. They're like cutting fruit or something. Taylor tells the same story to Harley that she did to Ingrid about, this is a secret. Like, don't tell anybody, but the house next door, how she wants to change it and all that. And Ingrid is just...
Bitch.
Bitch. Oh my god. Ingrid goes to the kitchen and she's like, hey, Hey guys, what you doing? Oh my god, Taylor, I totally started reading that book that you like so much.
Whatever the fucking deer creek.
Yeah, the deer room or something. Taylor is like, she has this like moment of panic and she completely changes the subject, forgets and kind of just like blows Ingrid off.
Yeah.
And says to her, like, oh my god, yeah, next time you're in, you know, you're in town, you and blah, blah, blah should come out to Joshua Tree and blah, blah, blah. We don't know why yet.
Yeah.
But we're just thinking, oh, Taylor found a new friend, but also someone that could help her career.
Right.
So Ingrid goes outside and Ezra's sitting down by the pool. He's very, very sad with like a bottle of wine, like with him. He spills all the tea.
Yeah.
About Taylor. Like he hates who she has become. He hates how she allows Nikki to do whatever he wants and takes money from her. And that when Taylor moved to LA, she was nobody with no friends. She was like this preppy sorority girl.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't until she moved to LA that she became this like totally different person. And he hates it. He is unhappy and he hates it. Ingrid, I think, like, she really like felt for him because he was like, I'm so sorry. I'm like laying all this on you. Like, I really do not have anyone to talk to about anything. And she's like, no, I get it.
Yeah.
It's fine. But then she tells Ezra about the Joshua Tree next door house plan. And she Ezra's like, what? What are you talking about? Like, oh, she wants to name it Desert Door. It's about her, named after her favorite book and whatever. And he's like, Taylor has never read that book.
No.
That's my favorite book. She doesn't know anything about it.
Right.
It's all, he's exposing Taylor, saying she's fake. It's all a fucking lie. I'd be pissed.
Yeah.
Even if I was Ingrid or not, I'd be fucking pissed. But Ingrid can't find her phone.
Yeah.
And I believe she, like, actually, like, realized, okay, it was Nikki.
Mm-hmm.
He took my phone. So she's looking around the house, and she opens the door, and Nikki's in some room doing coke. He's, like, supposed to be sober. This part, this is when shit, like, starts to get, like, really real.
Yeah.
Because he's like, oh, Ola, come in, come in. You want some coke? And she's like, come on, Nikki, where's my phone? Like, mm-hmm. I know you took it. He's like, yeah, I have your phone. And it's really funny. He starts to, like, kind of play around, but she, like, starts to get a little closer to him, and he's like,
don't fucking reach to me.
Yes. Whew. That's when it gets real. And he looked through her phone. It's like, it's funny. You have all these pictures of my sister's bathroom and her medicine cabinet. And there are a lot of pictures of you and my sister while she's sleeping.
Yeah.
And of course, Ingrid's like, oh my god, it's such a joke. Like, it's just a joke between us. Blah, yeah. Blah.
Your password is her birthday.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Ingrid's password to her phone is Taylor's fucking birthday. It's like, hello, we are back in reality. Ingrid is
psycho.
There is something very, very wrong with her.
Right.
And he gets very stern with her.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just like, you know, like, sit the fuck down. Like, you are gonna fucking listen to me because you are stalking my fucking sister.
Right.
He totally confronts her. But then he kind of like turns it around to becoming the villain again. Because she asks, all right, what do you want? He's like, I don't want anything. I'm just looking after my sister. But I want $5,000
a month
or like a week or something, which is crazy, but I guess it works for LA.
Right.
Yeah, to get that. And of course she doesn't have it. I don't know. What did you think about the whole blackmail thing? Like with Nikki as like a character, he's like, oh, I'm looking out for my sister.
You know, Nikki was such a fucking piece of shit character, and I did not like Nikki. I did not like his character at all.
In a good way or a bad way?
I found him annoying as fuck.
Yeah.
From the minute that he stepped in, it didn't even really matter because that Ingrid is psychotic and whatever, because I saw a character that was just as broken.
Mm-hmm.
And I just got so annoyed because it was like, dude, first off, she is a female. You've never met her. And your first instinct is to karate chop at her neck.
Mm-hmm.
And they go, yeah! Like, I'm sorry, dudes that do that, they're fucking dumb.
Mm-hmm.
And when the whole doing coke and shit, meeting with her and like, sit the fuck down. What are you going to do to this fucking female? You're going to beat the shit out of this fucking female. Mm-hmm. Shut the fuck up and sit the fuck down, bitch. You're nothing. Mm-hmm. Be gone.
Yeah.
And that was a pattern that I saw throughout this film, was men strong arming this fucking female. And I don't really like get where they were going with it, but it was kind of like, I didn't like it. Mm-hmm. I didn't like it that, like, the men were the strong arm ones all the time. Like, Taylor couldn't handle her own fucking baggage. Ezra always had to do something. You know, Nikki, the guy in the beginning that tackled Ingrid, it was like, no woman in this film can defend herself. Even Ingrid.
Interesting.
Even Ingrid. Because we're about to talk about something that she does.
Yes.
That will kind of heighten what I'm talking about.
I didn't even
think about that. Was something that really like that. Did annoy me. I was like, because I hate men that do that to women in general. And seeing that in this film, I was like, I fucking hate where this is going. I hate it.
Oh my god, this is really
enticing.
I can't wait.
Yeah,
I'm excited. But yeah, he is a piece of shit, because if he was a good brother, he would tell Taylor immediately and then
he would
go
tell
to the
Taylor
police.
He would go to the police. He wouldn't try to blackmail this fucking psycho cunt and allow her to keep doing what the fuck she's doing.
Exactly.
You know.
So Ingrid's like panicking. She doesn't know what to do. She, like, her and Dan are like driving, and she sees like a bus stop ad that says, like, it was a picture of a woman, like, that's beaten up, and it says, oh, domestic violence, call somebody, talk about it. So she gets the idea to, she found a bunch of teenagers and said, hey, I'll pay you $200 to punch me as hard as you can.
Yeah. And at first they were like, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah. They were so like, no.
Yeah.
But.
And then one was like, fine, whatever, I'll do it.
Yeah. So Ingrid uses Dan. She plays the damsel in distress in a Batman movie.
Yeah.
And of course he's pissed. Because she puts out this story saying, oh my god, when you dropped me off, I got home and Nikki was at my house and he like threatened me and he beat me up and he like said, and he's trying to like blackmail me for like $5,000, and I told him I didn't have that money, but she did have on Dan that she said that Dan mentioned something to Nikki about
the money
that was inherited from her mom. But he was like, what?
That don't sound like Nick.
That doesn't sound like Nick.
Yeah, because you know through one fucking night, which this movie is so fucking good about.
It's a theme.
One fucking night of people and you know who the fuck they are. Get the fuck out of here.
I don't know, man. We were drinking and we were just getting to talking, and I can't believe Nick would do something like this. It doesn't sound like Nick. We're supposed to go to Six Flags next week or something.
Jesus Christ.
But yeah, she convinces him that he's this violent person and he beat her up. So I don't know how, but she convinced Dan to, like, they get this van.
Yeah.
They're in these, like, masks. And they're gonna kidnap
Nikki. Yeah.
Well, she plays the whole hero thing. Like, you're a Batman, right? I thought you were Batman.
I am Batman.
And she plays it well. And he's, like, holding her. He's like, shh, no. I got you. No, it's okay. I'm gonna make this right.
Yeah.
So they attempt to do the kidnap thing, and it...
And Nikki's just like, aha, you guys are funny. Like, he pulls a gun, quote, on Nikki, and...
Well, first...
What?
Well, Dan, because Nikki's going into his car, about to leave, and Dan puts the gun to his head and says, you do it, I can't do it.
What did he say?
He did the Batman voice.
Right, but I don't know what he said.
Don't move.
Don't move.
Yeah, he does a Christian Bale Batman voice.
Get out of the car.
Yeah. So they have like a bag over Nikki's head and they like zip tie his wrists. But
no, they
like,
handcuffed him.
Was it handcuffs?
It was handcuffs.
It was handcuffs?
But they did it in front.
Yeah, he's like, hey, aren't you supposed, I don't know, I'm not like an expert, but aren't you supposed to put these behind the person's back? Like, you guys didn't think this through, did you? Who in their right mind would kidnap
me? Do this
me?
To me. Olga, is that you, Olga? See, that was funny.
Yeah. Who did you get
to help you?
Yeah. You thought that was funny?
Yeah. I did think that him in the back of the van, because it was true. It was like, they're so stupid about it.
It was very, very amateur.
Yeah.
So, I guess they, like, drove Nikki to, like, a canyon.
Yeah.
I guess the whole plan was just to threaten him and scare him.
Yeah.
Because Dan comes out with the gun, like, if you leave Ingrid Thornburn alone and...
We won't do nothing to him.
Yeah. Nikki's like, oh, do you know that this...
You do know that this is see-through, right? And then he kicks dirt or sand into Dan's eyes, and then they have a fight. And both of them equally kind of fuck each other up.
They do.
But then Nikki starts... He shoots Dan in the mouth with what we find out is a paintball pistol.
Yeah.
So...
What?
It's just so stupid. Paintball pistols do not look like fucking pistols. And the fact that they tried to, like... They had, a real gun, I think, in the beginning of the film in the truck. I think, because you don't really get to see it. You just hear her go, is that a real gun? And then you can really tell in the silhouette that it's not a real gun. It looks like...
I didn't pay it really
attention. Yeah, it doesn't look like a real fucking gun.
Yeah, well, I guess they did it right.
I guess.
I don't have
a fucking paintball pistol, and I've never honestly ever seen anybody with one, but I do feel like that they would still need a tank to shoot the fucking, and the fact that we didn't see one is just like, okay. But anywho, Nikki shoots him, and you just see white, the money shot all over his fucking lips. And you see that shit, and he's like, don't shoot me. And he goes, paintball gun, you kidnap me, take me to the fucking desert with a paintball gun. And then he starts beating the shit out of Dan with it.
With the fucking gun,
and that's
gun,
where it started honestly getting real.
Yes.
Because it was like, okay, dude, he's beating her to, he's gonna fucking kill
Dan. Beat
him
to death, yeah.
Because those things are fucking heavy now, they're metal. And Ingrid comes out of nowhere with a fucking crowbar and just whacks fucking Nikki.
In the back of the fucking head,
and he just drops, and then she takes Dan to the hospital, waiting there. What's-her-fucks calls...
Ingrid. Taylor.
Taylor calls Ingrid. Have you seen Nikki? Because he's missing.
No, I bet he just went back to Paris or whatever. I bet he's fine.
How fucking stupid.
But, do you want to get coffee and talk about it?
So stupid.
That was another thing that Ingrid would say a lot. Oh, do you want to talk about it?
Yeah.
I don't know where she heard that.
So dumb.
But yeah, I guess I don't know if like Taylor really called her to really see if Nikki is okay or asking about him, or Nikki came to, went to Taylor, and Taylor is calling Ingrid to try to get the truth out of her. We don't get.
Yeah, we don't really know.
We don't know. We don't get told that. So that's up to the viewer to be like, oh, okay, maybe she like, well, of course she's going to be super.
Yeah.
Scared if he hasn't been around. Yeah, Dan's like stuck in the hospital. He's like asleep. He has like his face is all fucked up. He has like a neck brace.
Yeah.
So Ingrid can't get a hold of Taylor.
Right.
She doesn't know why. So she's like going on her Instagram and there are these posts of like, oh, last minute trip to Joshua Tree, hashtag blue. And then another post is of her doing like a margarita. It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Yeah.
Very that. So Ingrid just automatically assumed, okay, they're at Joshua Tree. I gotta go there.
Right.
She goes and she actually like goes up to the fucking house, like bangs on their windows and no one's there. Ingrid calls and says, hey, I see that you guys are at Joshua Tree and I'm just like so randomly there at a yoga retreat. Maybe we can get together. It was
Ezra
who picked up the phone and said, Taylor doesn't
want to talk to you. Yes. You're a psycho bitch. Nikki told us everything.
Yes. Da, 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 da. Nikki said everything. Like, do not call again. Do not like.
The only reason we didn't call the cops is because he tried to blackmail you.
Yes.
Which they still could have called the fucking cops.
They still could have, but, you know.
Because he got kidnapped, so I know.
Yes, true. But Ingrid was not backing down. She kept calling and calling and calling and leaving message after message. And it got to a point where she's like, listen, you fucking bitch!
Yeah.
Like,
she turned into how she turned into the beginning.
Exactly.
Fucking cunt!
Yeah, this is like the moment where we see her shift to stalker to fucking psycho.
Yeah.
And after that hate message, she leaves another one and goes, "Hey, I'm so sorry about that last message. I was just kidding. Like, please, you know, I'll be here. I still have a couple things to do out here, so just call me back." Oh, hey, that's you calling. Ezra is calling Ingrid and said, "Listen, we are going to the cops." Like, he gets more threatening, yeah. Like, to Ingrid.
"It's 3 a.m, morning, bitch."
Exactly. Like, yeah. "Stop calling us. It's 3 a.m. Get a life. Whatever." So Ingrid, like, sleeps in her truck.
In Dan's truck.
Dan's truck. And the postman, whatever, tries to wake her up. It's, like, really hot. But she sees the for sale sign thing for the house next door. Mm-hmm. She goes to the guy and she wants to buy the house next door. And the guy's like, "Well, there's already a couple that put down an offer." She pulls out her little JanSport backpack. And here's what gets, it's questionable with like the money.
Yeah.
Because she drops all her money on his desk and is like, "That's $50,000.
Count it.
She came to LA, minus the plane ticket and whatever, with $60,000. That doesn't really add up to me.
No, it doesn't.
I know LA is expensive, and Venice is very, very expensive, but she spent only like $10,000?
Yeah, that's what it sounds like. And we don't know the timeline.
We don't know the timeline, that's true.
She spent $1,200, $200, $3,000, however much money, but it just, again, you are right. We don't know necessarily what. It doesn't add up.
Yeah.
Because if her rent is
$2,900
and it just makes no sense.
Yeah. That doesn't make sense.
But again, we don't know the timeline. How long everything has been.
Very, very true. It could be super, super fast. Maybe it could be the span of like
this
only a month.
This all happened in fucking days.
Yes.
And they're all that dumb, it probably fucking did.
So the guy goes for it. She moves in next door.
To the house that Taylor wanted to buy.
In
Joshua Tree, yeah.
And she, like, fully becomes, like, stalker mode, and she
disgusting hermit, can't pay for anything.
Oh, my God.
Bugs all over the fucking all over the house.
Yeah, because she blew all her money on buying the house. She couldn't pay for any of the utilities. She had no water. She had no electricity. She was trying to, like, make other, like, accounts.
Yeah.
And they were just, like, everything was bouncing. And this is really when the movie gets, like, super dark, too. Like, more dark than the whole blackmail thing. So she's still trying to get a hold of Taylor. The house has just... It's just full of, like, trash, bottles. Even the fucking toilet got clogged. She ran out of toilet paper.
Well, she was dumb. She used paper.
Yeah, she saw the book that she thought Taylor was obsessed with and used that as toilet paper. She
goes and
flushed it. It didn't work, of course. So she goes to the convenience store. I know you like that part.
Oh, yeah. She goes to the convenience store and has however much money she has and pays pretty much in coins.
A buck and change.
And tries to get a six-pack of Corona, toilet paper, and that's it. And then the guy goes, "Yeah, it's not enough." And she goes, he was like, "Do you want to take something out?" And she was like, "Come on, man. It's like Halloween.
It's Halloween.
Can't you just do it?" And I just love that dude because he just looks at her and he just goes, "No." I was like, God, I love that. That's
best
so real.
Best performance, yeah.
That's fucking real
performance
life.
Of the night.
Come on, man. Can't you just have a heart? No.
No.
Fuck you. Anywho, and then she clearly gives back the toilet paper and takes the Corona.
Yeah, she decides to, okay, fine, I don't need toilet paper.
I'll just do the six pack.
Exactly. And she's also attempting to text Dan.
Yeah.
But he's not responding, but
then he starts to respond
and then her phone goes dead. The electricity went out.
Right. The electricity goes out and then she hears, of course, another favorite part, the obsession song. "And my obsession" was going on next door. They're throwing a party. Taylor
and Ezra at their house
at
next
their
door.
House, yeah. So she tries to sneak over wearing a fucking sheet as a ghost.
A bed sheet and like a pink wig. It's like a bob
yeah.
kind of cut.
Goes over there, plugs her phone in, Somebody steps on her sheet. She falls, tumbles, and then Taylor sees her.
Yeah, Taylor's dressed as Cher from Clueless, and Ezra is the dude, I'm thinking, from...
Is he?
I think so. I think he
Which
was...
Which one?
The dude. I'm the dude. The dude.
Oh, but Lebowski. That's right, he was Lebowski.
Oh my god. Oh, shit. You're the fan of that movie.
He was Lebowski.
He was.
Well, I wasn't paying attention to their fucking outfits.
Oh, I was. That's me. So... I love Ezra in this moment because, like you were saying, he was ready to fucking fight her.
I know.
He pulls his sleeves up.
He's like, let me take care of this babe.
Yeah.
I was like, get the fuck out.
Are you just going to beat the shit out of her?
This
I know
fucking
she's
female.
Psycho, but
yeah.
Yeah. Weird. Just
get out of here, you fucking
yeah.
bitch.
Yeah. But Taylor, she's got the pants in the relationship. Maybe. Ingrid says, can I just talk to you for 5 minutes? Come on. Please don't call the cops. I'm not going to do anything. I'm not going to hurt anybody. Just talk. And Taylor's like, okay. But Ingrid doesn't really have much to say at first. And Taylor, like, legit asks, like, are you, like, actually psycho? Is there something wrong with you? So there's that kind of, like, back and forth. Like, Ingrid's like, come on, it's just me. It's just Ingrid. I thought we were friends. Taylor, she's like, we were never friends because everything that you were during the, quote, friendship is all a lie.
Yeah.
Everything was a lie. But Ingrid kind of claps back and says, oh, I'm the liar? What about you? And starts to lay out her laundry and how she comes off as this perfect person with a perfect life. And, you know, Your brother's a drug addict, and your husband is an alcoholic who hates you.
Yeah.
So, it's hard.
Sorry about
it. Like, sorry, not sorry.
Yeah.
So there's, like, a lot of truth that gets spilled, but Taylor kind of has the last read and says, well, I'm not the one that is sick. And,
right.
Yeah.
Needs professional
help. And needs professional actual help, which is true.
Yeah.
Ingrid is just, she's broken. So I believe she goes back to...
She goes back to the house.
Is it the house next door?
Yeah.
I couldn't make it out if it was the house next door or the apartment.
It was the house next door because she had to put the candles on because she had no
Okay,
power.
That's right. But anyway, she is recording herself and it's really sad.
Yeah.
We don't really get to know how many followers she has.
I think they just said that she had like over 1,000.
Yeah, but before or after?
I guess before.
Before,
I don't know.
Okay. Because we really didn't get to see like how active she was on
right.
Instagram. It was more of her just following Taylor wherever she went.
Yeah.
But Ingrid's like, hey, I just wanted to come on and finally say this is really me. I've been posting everything to make it look like I live this fabulous LA life, but it's all a lie. I'm a loser. I'm pathetic, which were words that Taylor used. And she said, hey, I just wanted to come in and sit and show you the real me. This is me.
Yeah.
And she takes a bunch of pills. She lays down and plays the song that her and Taylor were singing to. Oh, my love.
Yeah.
And we think, okay, so she's killing herself.
Well, yeah.
It blacks out, and then we hear Ingrid. Ingrid wakes up. She's in a hospital.
Mm-hmm.
And Ingrid's, like, looking around, and there's, like, all these balloons and flowers. She's like, what's all this? And the nurse is like, oh, this is from all the people who care about you.
Yeah.
And all your fans. Speaking of, there's one right here that wants to see you. It's Dan. He's in this little, like, motorized scooter. They don't really, like, say, but did he, like...
Get paralyzed.
Did he get... Yeah.
That was my thing. I was like, what the fuck is this? He got hit in the fucking head. Yeah, all right. His fucking... Does he have fucking spinal damage? No, because he's moving perfectly fine on that fucking thing.
Yeah, it was weird.
Now, if that is a Ice Cube Jr., I don't know how to be fucking disabled thing, whatever. Or if that's just, I don't know, made no fucking sense.
It could be us being nitpicky.
Right, and I mean, sure, why
that's
not?
That's our job.
Yeah, but I found that annoying, and go ahead and continue.
So, Dan is like, of course, you know, this is someone that just, Ingrid, she attempted suicide, so it's a, you gotta be gentle with someone like
right.
that, because she has a million emotions going on, and he's he's very tiptoeing, like, hey, what's going on?
Yeah.
And he's like, where'd you go? Are you going to disappear on me again?
For 3 weeks.
So yeah. We get that type of timeline that she left and was at her new home at Joshua Tree for 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And she shakes her head, like, no. And she says that she feels stupid. And he's, like, trying to cheer her up. But he... Oh, God. I forgot. The first thing that Ingrid says when she wakes up is, where's my phone?
Right. Where's my phone?
My God. And then Dan's like, okay, I know what's going to...
Make you feel better.
Make you feel better. Turns out...
I'm fine, by the way.
I'm fine, by the way. Yeah, I wanted the scooter in black. But, you know, like, did you like the new Batmobile kind of thing? Yeah. I'm fine, by the way. Love it. So, yeah, Ingrid posted her suicide video on Instagram, and she became an internet sensation.
Right.
She has all these followers, all these people. Her video went viral. That's the word I was looking for. Thousands and thousands of people commented, and Ingrid gets her phone, and you start to kind of see some of the comments, but then you get to hear the comments.
Yeah.
And she even has her own hashtag.
Hashtag I am Ingrid.
I am Ingrid. Everybody loves you. So now she is insta-famous.
Yeah.
And that's what makes her happy. She got what she wanted.
Mm-hmm.
And then the movie just stops.
Yeah, it just ends.
That's the end. I'm glad that it ended that way. It was...
Are you?
Yeah, I am. Because it leaves you asking questions.
Yeah.
For me. Like, you can interpret the rest of the movie your own.
Right.
What did you think? It sounds like you think differently about the ending.
I wasn't a big fan. I don't know. I just wasn't... All right. So it just, for me, it made the fact of how social media can be very ridiculous. And this is just me.
Mm-hmm.
This is my take. I'm sorry. But if you make a video of attempting suicide and post it on a fucking
Instagram,
Facebook, social media platform, and now all of a sudden, all of these fucking people are reaching out to you going, oh, honey, it's fine. Oh, girl, hashtag I am Ingrid, you're doing great, blah, 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 because that's essentially what was happening.
Yeah. Pause your thought.
Okay.
Dan was the one that called 911.
Because, again, made no sense.
Yeah,
because he didn't know where she was. So how did they find her?
Because she posted it on social media and he follows her.
She posted the location.
Maybe. We don't know that.
So.
Anyway.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, okay. You can give me that. But, anywho, all of that shit, all of these fucking people are just like, you see somebody try to commit suicide, and it's just like, oh my God, honey, oh. Again, takes us back to the fucking beginning of the film. You don't know what type of fucking person she is. You just know that she's doing something that everybody on fucking line will be like, oh God, you know, tell somebody, do this, do that, suicide, it's a horrible thing, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
If you see something, say something.
If you see something, say something. So all these people that don't know that this chick is a fucking psychotic nut job is fucking killing herself. So now she is the victim. Mm-hmm. Yet again, we now went from her being this psychopath to a fucking victim. And that is what, I'm sorry, some social media fucking is. So many people on fucking social media are so ignorant to the fact that they look at these fucking videos and they go, oh my God, it's real. It's like, no, it isn't, you fucking twats.
Mm-hmm.
Like, open your fucking eyes for a minute. And then a week goes by and you find a completely different fucking story from the story that it was. And it's like, that's all it is. Social media is fucking, it is. It's the fucking media playing with the fucking humanity.
And I believe the movie did that on purpose.
No, I'm sure it did.
Yes, to show that's us
me
that.
Saying, no, and I agree.
Yeah.
I agree. Yeah. I just don't, I don't like it because it makes me go, oh my God, yet a fucking again. Here we go with social fucking media.
Yep.
So, again, I'm not going to say this is a bad film because it's not. I did enjoy this film.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, I do. But from whatever you said earlier in the night when you were like, it doesn't show us that. But it does.
It does both.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like the obsessive personalities, the whole validation that is... That people crave, that, I mean, I'm not gonna say just people, like, people, we crave for the attention right. for of what social media gives us.
Yeah, no.
But this movie, it's a cycle. It's a circle that just keeps going and going and going. Here, okay, it's just going to be a different cycle. She's the one now, I think, that's going to be the sensation, and she'll
I'm sorry. It's right up there with fucking Catch Me Outside, bitch. Catch Me Outside, how about that?
Yeah.
Like, this bitch fucking gets fame because she just is a horrible human being and is on fucking...
Yeah.
Dr. fucking Phil, whatever the fuck, PhD.
Yeah.
Who is kind of, I guess, a nut in his own right.
He's a horrible, horrible person.
Right, but it's like, that's fucking, that's the media, man. That's no, it fucking...
Is. And now she became like a raptress. I don't hear anything about her now.
Right.
But at the time, that's how it works now.
I know.
Think, and this movie is so awesomely puts it out there.
Right.
For real.
Yeah.
And that's how it works. That's why I love this movie.
I know, yeah. So it's good.
Yeah. Would you watch this movie without me, though?
It's a really good question.
Is it?
It is, actually. I don't think so.
I do. Now,
to say that it was a bad movie, absolutely not. Mm-hmm. Because I did like this movie. I loved Aubrey Plaza's... I loved her performance. I loved everybody's performance, believe it or not.
Yeah.
Billy Magnuson, however the fuck you say his name, Nikki.
Magnuson.
Nikki was a pain in the fucking ass, and I did not like it, which I guess makes him a really good actor. But, you know, but again, it was just like all of these weird things. Like, what were they trying to go for with the men overpowering? Well, maybe that's what it was.
Maybe
they were calling out.
There were themes.
They were calling out all these themes. Maybe you kind of hit the nail on the fucking head. They were calling out all these fucking themes. Like, men, like, oh no, it's all right. I can beat the fuck out of this girl.
Yeah.
And it's like, all right, dude, fucking back off. You know, the fucking shit, cocaine.
Mm.
You keep that in mind. You know, the cops didn't do absolutely anything. Yeah. The fucking young Ice Cube.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and even when she was like, oh yeah, we did all your coke. Those cops didn't fucking go, oh hey, wait a minute.
Yeah, hold up.
But honestly, yeah, the movie did pick at, it picked at society.
It pulled the curtain.
There you go.
From a lot of things that didn't get talked about at the time.
Right.
And it did it.
Yeah, this was 2017.
Yeah, this was such... that's why I see this movie. This is such an artistic film that didn't get the mainstream applause that it should have.
Right.
But at the same time, it's like, of course it didn't. But I love it even more because it's that...
Right.
Because it's artsy and independent and...
But again... Not a horrible film at all.
Mm-mm.
Really well done.
Yeah.
I did like it.
Like, totally, I recommend. If you guys have stuck with us for... This is going to be a longer episode than normal.
Yeah.
But it's... I don't care. It's been...
This is society.
Society. It's been a long couple weeks for us. We were on vacation. Exciting. But we also had shit to talk about. And we're having fun because we haven't recorded in a while.
I know, exactly.
Yeah. So,
but anywho,
this is a movie to definitely watch if you have not. No. Just once.
Just watch it once. It's definitely a give it a chance.
Give it a chance.
It's a give it a chance film.
What's next?
Okay.
What are you going to choose for me to watch?
Okay. So honestly, I was like up in the air. I was like, God, what do I want to do? But because of, you know, Thomas's film, I was like, oh God, I would love to do that. But honestly, I don't. Unfortunately, sometimes we do have to see movies more than fucking once sometimes.
Yeah, we do.
If we have to talk about them, so that would be very difficult to do.
Yeah.
But I wanted to do this film, and I didn't do this film last time because I'm a jackass. So we just left Los Angeles, and it's only fucking right, and I haven't done a Quentin film yet.
No, we have not.
We're doing fucking Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
Yay!
Yeah, so we're going to do something newer, something that just somehow came out.
And I have not seen.
Right.
This is...
I saw it in theaters with the cream.
Yes, with cream.
And it was fucking amazing when
I'm
mad
at myself that I didn't see it, I just didn't have the opportunity.
No, but we're going to watch
now
it.
Now that it's out and
we're
available.
We're going to contemplate it. Yes. Contemplators. Prep yourselves. If you haven't seen it, please watch it, and then we'll talk about it next week.
Next week. You're back weekly.
Yay. So, everybody, whoa, we're getting ahead of ourselves yet again.
Oh, boy.
All righty. Back to the handy-dandy Shakespearean notebook.
Notebook. Okay, who is the cuckoldly, motley-minded fleshmonger?
No, I'm going to say it was very much Ingrid.
Yeah, I would say that. I would say it would be between her and Dan. I think it's a tie.
Between Dan?
Yeah, because he was very foolish.
No, but Dan's very foolish, yeah. He's very dumb. Hashtag,
you're dumb.
But the cuckoldly, that word makes it more Ingrid.
Yeah.
I think. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No, I agree.
Yeah, I don't know.
I think it's Ingrid.
What do you guys think?
I'm saying bye.
Yeah, this was a hard one.
Yeah.
But.
All right. So, everybody, thank you so much for joining us again. Wonderful night of contemplating. You can find us on all podcasting platforms.
Yes, give us a review, 5 stars if you can.
If you so desire.
Yes, we are all over social media. We are on Twitter, movies_pod. We are on Instagram, movies.contemplation_pod. Both Drog and I are on those.
Drog's attempting hashtag.
Hashtag
Drog is attempting.
Attempting, yeah. And we are on Facebook, Movies and Contemplation. And we also have email, movies.contemplation@gmail.com. Right. We're staying in L.A.
Staying in L.A., cats.
Yes.
All right. Everybody, thank you again, and we will see you cats next time.
Love you guys. Bye.
Bye.